They say the good angels come in myriads and the bad angels come in legions. What would it mean to re-legion? Would this not mean to gather more troops to a previously depleted legion? Even deeper, how did their legions become depleted anyway? Could it be that various beings such as the Venusians had been defeated before and fled to our galaxy? I believe so, and that is why we have to make sure to not join their ranks, and if we know we have joined them through one folly or another, disavow. I.e. ill as in not well, sick, like the so-called illuminated Illuminati and their illusions. J.A.L. Pathetic. These losers are using magic to imprison people, thus most criminals are really victims. The code is so heavy it is a wonder we all aren't insane criminals, even though many are, and silently act it out in their mind or on video games. Behold, look what things have come to. Man traps his brother in cages like animals for profit. The legal system itself I took personal interest in. All the post offices and courthouses that belong to the United States are all built with the same granite, no matter how far they have to ship it. This granite comes from Elberton, Georgia. Crystals and stones, 76 page, can be programmed with intent, and since all the stones come from the same place, it all holds the same unique frequency. The police officer is a Mason, the judge is a Mason, the lawyer is a Mason, and the prison guard is a Mason. From the time one gets in the system, they are in the hands of the Mason's modern-day slavery chain. Reason 59. One of the unseen hands of the real Illuminati. This is how they have received information of such high caliber on the subject of galactic domination. They do abide by a strict hierarchy. Those who join are so far on the bottom of the pyramid they get crushed by the titans on the top, thus they are putty in the hands of these beings who must be dealt with by the enlightened human on astral planes. One cannot concentrate too long on why they are doing this. The light does not comprehend the darkness. 77 page. Reason 60. Another part of the unseen hand is the red dragon. They are not shy in telling you they serve him. Their symbol is also the lion and the serpent, false wisdom and nobility. Evil has found a willing servant. Spoken by George Bush. L.A.L. Leo, the lion who has been lying since the beginning, proposing to be the Leghst of the world and the king of the beasts. The best depiction of the lion is on The Wizard of Oz, and they now lack the courage to face what they have done. Mail, mail, mail. This is the exciting part about the code. Sometimes you crack into things that have such a deeper meaning that you know you still have a lot to learn. This is a powerful term all the way around. It is used to denote the masculine sex and its relationship to Ma. A book written on secret societies spoke of a brotherhood of Ma that predated most secret societies, period. This brotherhood, 78 page, was said to be in conjunction with Mars and Moldek, a planet in our system that was destroyed. This is also a form of communication and a form of armor, as in chainmail. Nail, nail. I was in deep meditation one time and I was asking about the T, and why it was so important to Christianity as in the Trinity. When I finally got a response, it said the T is a nail, James, and that blew my mind. Obviously I get excited easily, but seriously, I knew there was definitely a connection with Jesus being nailed to the cross, which is what they emphasize the most when they reenact that whole terrible scene of the sacrifice. Nails and hooks in magic all have some weird dark use. What is being clearly shown as sharp objects that poke like forks, the devil's fork, swords, daggers are all tools of darkness. The devil is often called a nail. This doesn't mean to freak out next time you're at the dinner table, but what you will find is most indigenous cultures eat with their hands. Cutting and poking things clearly has its own subconscious effects and was the real sign of savagery. Oil, oil, the destruction of mankind on Earth. I was swimming the other day in the ocean and I could not help but to notice the amount of plastic washing up on the shore. Since I feast on vegetables and fruit, I can throw the rinds and peelings in the compost, but the plastic must be thrown in the trash. I started noticing just how much plastic is really in circulation just between bags for nuts, groceries, Ziplocs, etc. Every time someone tries to disarm your intent on changing things, attempting to make you believe that everything is okay and it's just all a new mind, think of the plastic. When they try to unmask love and light, you telling you to consider only yourself, Consider the plastic and how it's choking and suffocating our mother. The government could ban plastic right now and big industry would be forced to use the alternative that has already been laid out for them, but they will not do it because we have to overthrow them on the spiritual plane first. It is their things can be handled, it only takes one of us and thousands of them fall by the wayside, mighty we are, immortalis. Pale an angel that spends more than 7 days on earth is substantialized and becomes pale and opaque. Many of them dispersed into Canaan called afterwards, Palestine, which is now Israel. They swept the world with terror, those who also came from the Isles of Albion, which is Britain. They looked lifeless. This is where the term albino comes from. Venusians have this same appearance. Quail quail still wondering why this is the state bird of California? Real real, this is as real as it gets. As you see, you are on the target. This is what is really going on, not the illusion, and of course their latest addition to unguided spiritual mayhem, Rael, who is most assuredly down with the diabolical plan inciting his followers to all-out blasphemy and hedonism. In this condition they can do little for the world. 79 PAGE. Reason 61. The country of Canada is actually funding Rael to go about his ministry of basically do whatever you want. There is no God, just another hedonist cult on the surface. However, because they are linked with Thule, as you can see by their medallions, I knew they had to be up to more. Sure enough, they run an actual baby cloning facility where a mother who has suffered a miscarriage can actually have the baby. They use the blood and DNA of the deceased baby and make a new one. Of course, this is a very expensive procedure, so they attract very wealthy candidates. This is like the movie Omen, where these evil babies were put into wealthy households to later control major companies. Earthy away, this is big time ET action. Rael has at least a dozen surrogate mothers on staff waiting to hatch a baby. Their website promotes all of this, no legal problems whatsoever, pure Zionist breaking all the rules they enforce. Sail sail seal, what you will find with the serpent energy, since each S is a symbol for a serpent like Hitler's SS. Cracking the code, when you come to the S words, swords, they always are deeply embedded with meaning. Now sale and deal go together, and that makes business, the art of swindling our poor fellows. On the other hand, when it comes down to it, magical seals are the most powerful. The purpose of a seal is to close something and thus trapping it to do bidding or holding it so it won't escape. Solomon's seal, which is the Star of David, was designed to do just that, trap things. When Solomon would seal gin in bottles, he would put the Star of David on top. Once again, you can see that even Metatron's cube, which has hit the number one spot in sacred geometry, is none other than a hex used time and time again to keep souls which are seeking higher truth passing back and forth between this demented dimension and Saturn. It is a mental weakening tool, as many have already admitted, since its main purpose is only to weaken the cube. It should never be placed in the mind. 80 PAGE. Reason 62. The knowledge of the organic cube was taken from Egypt, now given the title the Flower of Life. The Egyptians used this to visually encase matter within it. Then it was used to move things, especially large objects, around with their minds. Meditating on this geometric shape incorrectly will help solidify the cubic frame of the body we are already trapped in, thus it is not the chariot. The real purpose for these shapes is an art called tesseract, which is the shape you see on the right. This is for bringing things into this dimension from the June 4th proton, 6 electrons, 6 neutrons. Our body is the carbon structure of the cube, the beast, but not our spirit. The Flower of Life later became Metatron's cube when the lines were made straight. Tail tail tail, we come to our favorite reptilian appendage, the tail, along with the word always used for the erroneous stories we are told, especially as children, that is fairy tales, wives' tales, and tall tales. Veil veil, a very powerful word from my point of view. This is what creates the illusion. The world walks about veil, meaning unable to see the truth. Wail whale whale, to continuously cry, and our aquatic friends known to originate on the aquatic moon Europa and also Sirius along with dolphins. Yael yale yale, to scream, and also the famous university which still has the seal of the Urim and the Thuim, the ancient Hebraic rune stones. These are object of magic used by the Levite priest. This is also the home of Skull and Bones code number March 22, 322 turn of the equinox. 81 PAGE. Reason 63. The name was placed under the breastplate and would cause it to glow, opening communication to the Tetragrammaton. Lucifer also had his body encrusted with special stones. Zeal. It is noted in the Bible a man named Phinehas showed zeal, meaning in this case lots of aggressive energy to rain destruction upon the Gentiles and go to murder for God, and this was shined upon. There are numerous ancestral tribes with an abundance of blood on their hands. If we chose to follow their religions, we will share their same fate. Keep in mind, many indigenous tribes claim to learn the worship of the serpent from Atlanteans who arrived on their coasts with abnormal powers after the destruction of their city in the late month of Ether, which is our October. Eth is pronounced 8. October is our 10th month, but Octo means 8. This shows you how purposely off the Gregorian calendar is. As I said above, 2012 is happening now. As you see with this simple four-letter word that we have examined, there is a lot more to be extracted from language. Due to the truth itself never being written nowhere near its entirety, this provides one of the only ways to extract the manifold story of what happened here on Earth. It survives in the language. Societies like the Druids never wrote anything down, thus everything of value, 82 PAGE, was committed to memory. As it states in several places, the memory banks of man and woman were a lot more vast than they are now. They did not have to write things down. Even looking in Egypt, it has been discovered that even the hieroglyphs were a product of latter times in Egypt. The original inhabitants left no written records, just Chdi priests. This lends more credit to the results of magnetic shifts, which is extensive memory loss. I believe if a person does not have a strong sound aura, magnetic shifts can erase most past, present, and future information pertaining to the person. Reason 64. Our ancestors had at times larger brains and greater memory capacity. This is never talked about because of course it would destroy the theory of evolution. These skulls date back millions of years ago. The Bible starts the first creation of man at roughly 8,500 years ago. What a hindering lie. Sometimes when you are dreaming, you may even see people you knew in elementary school. However, if you are asked while conscious if you remember them in such detail, the answer for most will be no. Because so many quadrants of the brain are powered down, ultimately most people are walking about with a bad case of amnesia. When one forgets who they are, they become clones behaving like everyone else. People that can really see auras can read things off a person's aura, not just the mood of a person. It is known that information like where they have been, who their descendants are, and various other deeply enlightening things about their character. When examining the controllers of this system, I did come across extensive information indicating that pole shifts could now be caused by the technology in their possession, which had been used before in previous times to reverse the effects of a natural pole shift. Seeing 2012 line up as the Zionist code, it would indicate not only the ability to possibly cause shifts but also the ability to traverse the space-time continuum. Most make the mistake of calculating what everyone in the world is capable of based on their personal intelligence level, not realizing there are men who spend their every waking moment solving complex problems of quantum physics and various forms of science. One who spends their time in the club and drinking should not believe they are on the same caliber as these great minds. That is the ego that would believe such foolishness. It makes sense that they are doing nothing in vain and have truly discovered something far beyond the imagination of the common slacker. 83 PAGE. Reason 65. The date 2012 is actually the numeric code for Zion used across encrypted machines like the German Enigma and the code of the Psychonaut. The two is a Z, S, or N. As you can see the obvious similarities, the O1 is binary and can be interchanged, and finally the end is true. They will reach completion at least by 2012, although 2010 is the vivid beginning of the shift. The elite used Zion as the logo for the Olympics scheduled for Dubai, London in 2012. They are bluntly pushing forward. These topics are never covered and are strictly out of the box. A long debate will go on amongst individuals questioning whether or not time travel is possible. Sometimes they will go a little deeper and report things like the Philadelphia experiment, where it was purported a major project took place to create a jump hole between 1940 and 1980 approximately. Few ever make it to the point of questioning what was being done with this time gate. Let us ask the question, with the ability to traverse time still under the laws of physics, what would the elite want to change? That is a big question, but to me there is one simple answer. They would want to make themselves rule as long as possible, and anything that could disrupt that they would thwart somehow as long as possible. 84 page. Reason 66 on the left: a fresh jump gate installed right outside of downtown Detroit without the least bit of curiosity. Of course, who's looking at Detroit these days? On the right, the jump gate on Stargate SG-1 equipped with Enochian writing. You should begin to see how fact and what seems at times to be fiction blur together. Everything we can think does in fact already exist. We will talk a little of traversing space and time and how one can get in a position to even be able to accomplish such a feat unless they were spiritually inclined. It is known that if you are carrying a low vibration, you cannot physically travel through higher vibratory fields with the body, obviously, but you can get to other planes, planets and various territories with capable ships. This is what is meant by the term external Merkaba. When the space race began, it was Russia and the US. Let us start looking at all of the Russian territory known as the Great Bear as under one very divisive monarchy in which the people are expendable. Let us include even Germany in this, although many think the Russians don't like the Germans. That was something created by their mutual governments to formulate a plan of divide and conquer, which the elite do everywhere. They are all still Aryans. Vinvnivis, we just call it the V. Reason 67: Russia, a long-standing occult and technological powerhouse, made it to the moon first with ease. Their space technology was far more superior than the US, as they had already made deals with the Jazans. One would need to keep in mind Russia had one of the first inner circles. True, they lost many people in depressions and civil wars, but their elite continued to increase their ranks. Again, the people are expendable to them. Lenin, Trotsky, Stalin, Gorbachev, Putin and many others fed from Mother Russia like vampires at a blood bank. Not to mention that's where those that choose plasma as their diet get it from. No time to be hunting people in the night when you have to be in a Fortune 500 meeting in the morning. 85 page. The race was to the moon, as they say. One should start thinking what was really happening on the moon, since we know a silly race isn't the reason these two juggernauts take off on a goal. Furthermore, trust they would use every channel they could to be sure they could make the trips with the least amount of error. They would need star maps, statistics, temperatures, pressures, permissions and various other guides. Many think we just logically came across this information through trail and error, which would create enormous time issues for explaining how fast we prepared for the mission. Here is what really happened. In the spiritual circles of Thule during Third Reich Nazi Germany, the greatest magicians of all time had come together. Blavatsky was only a component of this group. Men like Dietrich Eckart, who trained Hitler, were far above her. Madame Blavatsky possessed an array of esoteric goodies she picked up from the Black Tibetans during her trip to Agartha Shambhala. In such a male-dominant society, Blavatsky entranced the mind of various key individuals with obviously not her physical charm. Books writing her off as a quack are disinformation. She begins her book Isis Unveiled with a stout beginning, making her allegiance in bath colors is known. Reason 68: Madame Petrova Blavatsky, mother of the Society of Thule, recruited the best magicians of the time. She made contact with the Black Tibetans known as the Green Gloves, found later scattered throughout defeated Nazi Germany in houses where they had committed mass suicides. The Green Gloves were hyperdimensional Tibetan masters. They showed Blavatsky Shambhala Agartha, the inner world. She made the pacts with them, and thus the Third Reich became the heavy instrument of the Dark Tibetans, all aligned with the Jazans. 86 page. This is how the swastika of the Black Sun got into circulation in Germany. Since once again we are in a binary world, we also have another sun directly on the opposite side of this sun. You have to be in special locations to see it. they refer to it as a sun dog. The black sun is the opposite energy, a taker of life for strength rather than a giver. Madame Blavatsky had Master El Noya, Saint Germain, Kudhumai, Sanat Kamara, Sananda, Alistair Crowley, M.C. Gregor Mather, Frater Akkad, Krishnamurti, Ledbetter, and Besant, all immortal masters of astral travel and devoted members of Great White Brotherhood. Reason 69. Rare images of a sundog, the view of our binary sun sometimes even appearing as three suns. These are government facilities fully staffed located far away from civilization on the poles, which are the only places you can see this phenomena. These places don't get visitors often, and if they do, they are not civilians. With this arsenal, Thule hatched a deeper plan in conjunction with the paranormal division of the Third Reich. Diros, their contact who wrote the new Emerald Tables of Thoth, dwelled in the underground city of Agartha. The paranormal division was said to receive more funding than Hitler's total armament division due to its importance to the Reich. They lay burdened with the task of gathering all the powerful shrines from around the world, which eventually ended up in the vaults of the British Museum. Those who have done study on holy artifacts will note that most of them are in the British Museum, not in their original place of origin. They won't allow it. Many of these objects do strange things when placed back on their corresponding ley lines. It is known you can only get into the vaults of the British Museum if you are a member of the Golden Dawn. The Golden Dawn was a society set up by Thule in which Aleister Crowley was made head of. He had Frater Akkad as his apprentice. Crowley and Mathers were always in competition with one another. This is how Blavatsky penned them against each other to broaden their potential. These two adepts birthed the greatest horrors mankind has witnessed in this era. Many of their works were published by Blavatsky's Lucy's Trust, again another obvious clue she was part of the Luciferian agenda. 87 PAGE. Reason 70. The Holy Grail and the Spear of Longinus, which was said to pierce the side of Christ, were both seized by Hitler. These artifacts are charged with energy due to the belief millions of people puts in them. Childhood stories of knights, princesses, and dragons all serve to mold the mind for future indoctrination. Most of these items had much different histories. The real grail was not even the chalice, it was a succession of women carrying pure bloodlines, like Mary. Alistair was far more sadistic than M.C. Gregor, it was he the beast decided to incarnate in. That did not go without the key use of M.C. Gregor, who had a gift for languages. M.C. Gregor was set to the task of translating the Keys of Solomon from ancient Hebrew to Latin and English. This had never been done, and it was awaited by every magician of the time, especially since not many had access to the libraries in the British Museum. After translation, M.C. Gregor's life was very short, and his scribe admits he had been affected by some curse which the book even warns of, called the reflux current. Dan Brown is scheduled to release his rendition of the Keys of Solomon to follow up his Angels and Demons. I sure hope you are off this plane when this hits the media and people in their curiosity download the original book, which is also available for free. The beast has incarnated in several men such as Jack Parsons, the creator of the nuclear bomb who was also a Satanist, Albert Pike the 33 Mason responsible for bringing new forms of the corrupted Brotherhood to the US, and of course Crowley who set Leviathan free. As they completed the circle of ceremony, all was silent, everything that needed to be said was said, the order, perfect, the incense, in measure, the offerings received. Investments they waited, and as time passed they assumed the ritual to be barren. Then there was a flash of energy as the portal opened, a green trapezoid, many collapsed with the sudden change in temperature as the deep cold permeated the room. They had done it, they had unleashed the ancient forbidden one. What have they done? They have released Leviathan, who is Cthulhu. Aleister Crowley's ritualistic experiments in Loch Ness. 88 PAGE. Reason 71. Left to right, Crowley, Pike, and Parson, the fleshly hosts of the beast. I will take a moment to elaborate on this book, The Keys to Solomon, since I personally believe it will play a huge role in the reality shift of this dimension for a few reasons. When Dan Brown released the Da Vinci Code, it was instantly a bestseller, meaning the media pushed it to the top fast. He followed up with Angels and Demons, and that solidified his career. They had the perfect puppet icon. Anything else he releases, people are going to swarm to. They warmed everyone back up again when they did the Da Vinci Code movie with everyone's favorite Mr. Forrest Gump, Tom Hanks. This gave Dan more prestige. Now they are finished with the Angels and Demons movie, and the subtitle is Revenge of the Nephilim, which you can do your own book on all of what that entails by now. So next, of course, will be The Keys to Solomon. The original book, The Key to Solomon, does not read like a story book. It is strictly talismans, prayers, repentances, evocations, and illustrations of ceremonial magic. It is not wise to speak against anything you do not understand. This book I understand very clearly is a horrible danger. Why? During the time I was a fresh pastor, I was fascinated with Solomon. He was who I chose as my archetype, as many men of the cloth often do. Solomon has all the wisdom and most affectionately all the ladies, something abolished after Solomon's time, but still it allows the deprived pastor to dream a little. I wanted to read everything Solomon wrote, especially since it actually says in Proverbs Solomon wrote over 5,000 books. I wondered why, if Solomon wrote 5,000 books, we only had 3 Psalms, Proverbs, and the Song of Solomon, one of which was not written by Solomon but by Lemuel. Some say Lemuel, Solomon, and Jedidiah were all the same person. I began to search and came across 2 more books, The Testaments of Solomon and The Keys to Solomon. Both were full of demons. In The Testament of Solomon, Solomon is actually interrogating demons under the power of the ring, which he says was given to him by YHVH. The Keys to Solomon had the names of demons inscribed in the talismans that it instructed you to make. Of course, I didn't know the names were those of demons, failing to do the translation from Hebrew to English at the moment. In addition, my Dictionary of Angels by Gustav was still on the way. But that wasn't going to stop me from exploring a little of Solomon's wondrous talismans, eh? 89 page. In short, after doing all of the rigorous work of constructing a talisman for wisdom, this is what happened. First, I will note that some of the rituals in the book involved animals' blood, which made me think a little deeper about Solomon. However, there were plenty that did not involve blood, and since there was also a warning in the beginning of the book about using animals' blood, I came to the terms that someone had maliciously put the spells there, since they were towards the back of the book. When I would fall asleep with the talisman or book around me, I would be transported to another world. Once I realized I was watching the dream, I could begin to control it, thus starting the lucid phase. From there, some monstrous form would appear and we would do battle, of which I noticed the seals from the Key to Solomon played a heavy role in trapping these demons once they had been subdued. Sustaining any kind of blow from them would result in real physical damage in this world. On one occasion, a demon got hold of me and slammed me before I could break the dream. When I woke up, I had the pain and the bruises. After that, I learned not to get grabbed. All along, I was imagining I was doing the Lord's work, in the army now. The dreams could always be broke by holy names, in which I kept a complete arsenal in memory. I also noted there were a lot of other people there, all involved in doing something in this strange world full of spirits. The demons got bigger and bigger, and I seemed to get better and better at dealing with them, and then the dictionary arrived. I was horrified to find that the talismans contain the names of demons. What I now know is that all the demons I was fighting I had evoked, and if I had lost, they could have done damage to my soul. I will tell the reader now, I was born on the 22nd, which is a master number, so I have a buffer that allows me to dissect these things without immediate danger to my soul due to positive intent. However, I know beyond doubt many have been taken by this book. Maybe my work about it will reach the people's hands in time so they can steer clear of it. Back to the plans of Thule. With the talismans of Solomon in hand, they began to travel the opposite plane, which anyone trained in lucid sleep can do. In this plane you can go to various places, and the main feature is you can call forth beings and they appear. Apparently they called forth the Enochian and Jane, sons of Cain, and they appeared to them. They consulted with them about world domination and how it could be brought about. They gave them first a special language of power to use amongst themselves in conjunction with real power. They gave them this strategy for using young minds as processors in universities. The idea was to use the brightest minds to develop devices to create external Merkaba. This vehicle could be used to travel dimensions, a real-time machine. The alchemist became the physicist. Following this in the scene world, we find Germany at the head of jet propulsion technology. The Allies and Axis were in the bed together behind the scenes, but in plain view they pretended to be enemies. The Black Sun cults, White Brotherhoods, Luciferian, Saturnalian, Atlanteans, and Venusians all had a mutual cause: galactic domination. Of course, declassified CIA project paperclip indicates the transferring of the German scientist during the staged fall of the Third Reich to U.S. soil, 9 APAGE. To W work for NASA. Basically, they destroyed G Germany, set up the Betelgeuse sacrifice known to man, eodate the Hollow Accost, to fay the Varied Orcris and other demoniac force they he working with. And as RGD they continued a plan few would even venture to believe. YDWN2. Reason 72 say several Nazi scientists W impor into THUS. That they were brought UIs were a TED he emery under the NASA umbrella to help with RUA chocket propulsion. THES rockets WES were not used to power used were spa shuttles but to kill innocent P-Pace SL people by TH1000ENDS. 91 PAGE. Reason 73 the hyperdimensional being known as Awas channeled through Crowley gave him a coded language of power to use amongst the Psychonauts which they came to be known as. Awas is also the sign of the single bolt in ancient Germanic which can be found in letters and numbers. Awas was the classic grey alien sent by the dark side as an extraterrestrial imposter. They are more similar to Gollum, two-part beings created by sorcerers that just follow orders. The idea was to rearrange occurrences in history to erect new saviors. We will call this project Eighth Ray, which I will get into more in the second edition, if there is a second edition. It takes at times to be showed this by higher beings to believe, my word can only stand for the guided who know of some of the things I have already spoken of and thus will venture to trust me further as I will still show how it all fits together, so reason, not belief, is needed. In many of the ancient paintings it shows what appears to be spaceships in the atmosphere during the crucifixion of Jesus. Those ships bear the eight-pointed star of Allah. These Allah are very advanced, which is why they control the world. Jesus was a Nazarite, a special sect of whom Samson and almost all prophets of the Bible belong to. This is the rites of Nazar who all leave this world at 33 years old. The part of the oath of the Nazarite is to never cut your hair. Samson and Jesus both left the world at age 33. When the German scientists came to the US they joined up with NASA. The S of course is a backward Z. They formed the new Nazi party who now have many angles they work from because they have unlocked the ability of hyperdimensional travel. Always remember the technology they show us in the open is the old stuff. Look how long the military was using microwave technology before they decided to let everyone else give it a spin introducing the microwave into the home. When the microwave hit the market people were amazed, look how fast it heats things, at a price of course, radiation which will always cause some form of cancer or tumor most times undetected. Reason 74 we will see a lot more of the Project Eighth Ray and their hyperdimensional capabilities. This means large pro-peace movements similar to the times of the hippies may have been removed from our memories. There may have been a lot more uprising in history than currently, 92 PAGE. Remembered, especially the Great B battle. I do not think I'm the first person to figure this out RST. However, I'm aware it is only except Ion or people who really discover T-truth to the Matrix they do AEY the OX, little work. And then they are removed as if they never existed in this world. But SL light little an alter and we perceive things different in the future which is shown o the Moes on UVIAM legend we the lady air why can Raymond Bob Marley in he memory, just Dame Marley the TV series her not bear MRE on why. Rose does an exceptional job at showing the cause and effect of all to BNG say it's ring the par. These subtle hint are often asked TSN drop PPED by TH elite Becky cause it ma makes them laugh on T other E the end when T those who know how it happened are W watching. This occurs a lot in Holt E Lywood movies. Reason 7 The Mo Common Person 75 O's 10 knows THTV is a mind con tool by he troll why various D degrees however that D not sto does op them through watching it. This is part of the ONG he mind con on troll. Many believe TH mind ne he control I only sug is just if how it is do ever one more fro a techno-omological standpoint. As the new digital NETW work is reaching complete in the UA very different key TIONUS kind of programming we ensue. L. Reason 76 SO Reasoni which is an anag H gram for SIO since an English THY is SU I on the substituted F and for I of cowers it makes sense come in from the company that has int I say S ing introduced TH world to some of EO its greatest tech S ecological gadgets of the time. That they are already let it back o known they will alfstingmn be adjusting T viewers DNA with a new DE the SH digital upgraders. When this begins there will be little NSL more mo one can do to EXPL and if into the MN laning masses, they simply will not be intel terrorized. TH will hey be dulled out and control ET rolled, embedded with layers of DH digitized men program NTAL lamming. 93 PAGE. Reason 77 MUSHRN rooms alien with NG hallucinogens like ayahuasca gate UK carway drugs, meaning TH once ta, that a can they op the pen gateway of your so which is normally kept all closed by default. An inexperienced per RSON can suffer F from several types of PL possessions W when taking these substances if they are not T or hey trained in the no knowledge of out of body experience FDY say OOBE as you say Dr. Mario Lerd Belie IO Lions of Children into take Isilosib Mushro Ening Binlums. It is said that the true purpose of a gallon DT lactic line U is to all up, low ascending and descending to ing O take place. Man will be coming and going fro this dim ini cd on mention on this happens. Thos who hold say d the power of creating realities, he can be dch done in the mind, can transfer so enul's minds to another esoritiental bridge. I know a person wh went to India and then Peru and testify of yogis e ho you yet really on a me bane able to tar and train students into their minds. Th the stud ng aknet ahendent was transferred in another ntor world in which the yogi was ruler. MLDHW Madame Blavatsky did say that the lower dimi mentions we ruled by air while the Buddhas o the Devon Vachanic planes above us thus PL lacing us in more of a lunion o realities and an of SRS TNSES, dimensions, and realms SD since this either case it would be as e lay of what we call planes, expand wise for one to seek how to escape T hold matter alto EO this together or at least how to go in the positive at WE. Direction pursue the Nagati as I've. If you do not Mac a Desi CO one will be made for UK on, or. Riso 78 Holly on Lywood lets us know one more E time T there are that a snake on the ears out play in the sim E. Billism is key. A you can say the as see cad cas bane your CSNG implicated as one of the knee culpri writs. 94 PAGE. I know for a fact that we have now descended two dimensions already. What Leonardo da Vinci was explaining in his paintings which are full of sacred geometry is the human body has a five-fold nature. Five senses, five fingers on each hand etc. There is an actual seam running down the middle of the body showing we are two five-fold sides put together. What is happening now is most people are operating on three senses versus the five senses they think they have. How this occurs is many people think they see but in fact they are not seeing true reality just illusion, some taste but they need seasoning to even enjoy the food not to mention the kind of food they eat for nourishment. Some would rather talk thus they don't hear well, and others touch but don't feel the energy of what they are examining. For each person the mixing and matching is different. The drawback is if we can't operate on all five senses not only can we not unlock the sixth sense, which is how you feel when all five senses are being used at their height simultaneously. In addition, it takes the six senses to unlock the seventh, and so on. As explained above, the perception of various dimensions is within the amount of senses you have. A good example of this is when the third eye is open, you are immediately perceptive of another dimension. To clarify the statement of many languages being backwards, I will bring forth a few facts. Fact 1 is that all holy languages, as they are called, like Arabic, Hebrew, Amharic, Aramaic, and Sanskrit, are written from right to left. English, Latin, French, and Spanish, also known as the Latin Vulgate, are all written in the opposite direction from left to right. The reason for this is the direction you read and write plays a heavy role in the direction your mind is moving, since the mind turns more of a wheel in thought. Also, this affects what side of the brain you predominantly use. Many of the words in these languages, especially the Vulgates, when looked at backwards or sounded out, the vibration when taken literal gives you the actual origin of the word and its manifold involvement in the erosion of the intelligence of the human race. Amor is the word for love in Spanish. Amor is the son of Venus. When you look at it backwards, it spells Roma, which is of course Rome. This proves that when you turn the word backwards, you don't get the opposite meaning, you just get more of the meaning. That is another valuable key to learn. Since letters are truly numbers, let's say ABC is 123. No matter how you move the words around, it will still equal 6. In English, love comes from Jove, wife of Jupiter. We can conclude a J is also an L, just facing the other direction. At times, what will be uncovered will be shocking and hard to believe. If you remain patient and strengthen your courage, you will see that this will become the key to your emancipation and self-empowerment. The system in place redundifies to the lowest degree. Once you are on the trail, you will find multiple connections. The art of magic itself involves an accurate system that cannot be altered too much, or else it will have no effect. Much power lies in repetition. This is why so many words are often spelled the same, but each is given a different meaning to increase its use. For this reason, it is easier to spot them once you know the basic parameters. Does this make sense? Since 95 page. If you may think for one moment that your mind is not directional, consider for a moment that the eyes see everything upside down first. They then must flip the image you see before it sends it to your brain, all of which happens so fast you never notice. As we may at times forget, we are actually standing on a globe that rotates and our feet are stuck to it by gravity, lest we just float off in space, so in fact we are at times upside down. If we are only using the two eyes as a gauge to authenticating higher life forms, we will remain disappointed at our discoveries. One must use other abilities in conjunction with their eyes, such as the third eye or pineal gland. Most have calcified pineal glands due mainly to fluoride intake, meat, processed starches and artificial sugars. To reverse this, one will need to ingest good amounts of gota cola, alfalfa, parsley, wood betony, and mugwort. Gota cola is by far the most effective of all these. Reason 79: the eyes are easy to be tricked. In fact, many places in our matrix have optical illusions over them, so you cannot perceive what is really there with your naked eye. As seen in folklore, they often spoke of hidden doorways to other dimensions. Focus your eyes on the dot in the center of this illustration. Now move your head back and forth. Notice the wheel spinning? Your perception can easily be manipulated by those who understand the complete body down to the atomic and cellular levels. 96 page. Reason 80: when looking at gates like the one pictured in Reason 66 in Detroit, you will never see anything enter or exit the gate. They remain on a frequency undetectable by the eye. This is not very hard. They have mastered invisibility because of the inaccuracy of the two eyes. The third eye, however, cannot be easily fooled. Focus on the cross in the center of the illustration. You will notice the dots disappear altogether. If you focus longer, they will reappear and then change color to green. There are a few things that should become obvious to the individual about many of the gods. Their worlds have run far longer than most can fathom, especially since we have a hard time remembering what we did last Saturday. I call this the war against the machines, except it didn't involve the Terminator, it was the terminal they used. The computer has the feature of a huge memory bank. I've seen computer hard drives into the terabytes, which is at least 999 gigabytes. The Cray 6, a government computer, has in its memory banks the dial tone of every phone in the United States. It's funny that to our ears when you pick up the phone the tone sounds the same as any other phone, but in fact they are all different. Part of what is happening to our short-term memory, which is very important because it makes the transfer to our long-term memory, is we store on computers everything we should remember on our own, thus our memory wilts down because it is unused. Even numbers of our close family members are stored in the phone memory banks, not our personal memory. Now people change numbers so much it becomes no use in remembering their number. When we stop logging numbers and watching them, an entire world of fact is closed to us. If you could watch the random numbers of the day, your every step would be guided in perfection. Numbers are what we call the master language. There will always be a 1, 2, 3 in every culture, thus it is the strongest language. As you see in the Kabbalah and the Abjad, there exist numeric magical cubes, boxes that equal the same amount no matter which way you add them. In short, we lost the battle of the machines on various levels. This is 97 PAGE. Just one. We must regain the desire to pay attention to letters, numbers, and names. This is the actual exposed program to the matrix. You can read it if you can decode it. Reason 80: the war against the machines took place in the office building, not on the battlefield. The real Terminator, Arnold Schwarzenegger, is busy at work dismantling our future. Sources say the elite are considering making him the next US president. For the first time that I have seen directly, we will reveal what is at the end of fourth dimension. You may see this as a briefing, since we will all reach a point where we must guide our spirit through the planes. Those that have become masters of astral travel report that when encountering and passing through fourth dimension, they knew not to stop. They reported heavy reptilian ET activity of a weird, unwelcoming kind. Upon reaching the end of the fourth region, there appeared what seemed to be an artificially intelligent computer barrier. Something like a giant computer that was alive, that made a noise as if some type of giant engine was running within it. Some would wave this off as absurd, and of course I would too if I didn't have something more to add about another strange sync with this Marchine. First off, we will note on the last Matrix movie it came down to Neo talking to the AI. Artificial intelligence and making some sort of deal in order to free the people from the Matrix, but that is just a movie, right? AI is actually an important city in ancient Sumeria. This word is pronounced I, like the all-seeing eye. The Atlanteans were also known as the Borgians, which is where the French term bourgeoisie comes from. They claim to be descendants of ancient Atlanteans. A Borg is known to be part human, part organic technology. If you have read any Atlantis lore, you will see their affinity for first crystals and then technology. We also report for those who had made it to the 98 PAGE point of the gate. If they could go that far, they had no trouble getting through. It had to open. I wonder if Bill knows about that gate. Oops. Reason 81: this synchromistic tarot card is right on the money, featuring as number 17 Borg. 17 is a favorite Masonic number, since 1 plus 7 equals 8. As you see, they deal with the double cube, and the cube is evil, just like they showed you in the Hellraiser movies. The Mason Center, the US, were charged with building the new Atlantis. Atlanta, Georgia has a lodge next to just about every church, if not the church itself. You have Great Athena, Athens right up the road, not to mention the Georgia Guidestones, Dr. Malachi York's pyramids in Eatonton, Georgia, the Olympic arrival of 1996, and many more things linking Atlanta as a key location for numerous plans brought forth throughout history to arrive us at where we are now. The tree in the middle of the garden with apples is wholly an Atlantean concept, just like the flood. The truth is, the masses have still been worshipping the same pagan gods throughout history, clueless to the outcome of such carelessness for the soul. When we fail to investigate the eternal destination of our spirit, it is most certain that it will end up in the hands of the vile. They want it, they know its value. This afterlife is serious, It is this world that is the illusion, and yet you even see in this world the innocent pay penalties in which we would think is unfair. This is not about fair and unfair, this is about you taking the training wheels off and becoming firm about what is your greatest possession rather than trusting it in the hands of some money-loving guru lest they lead you astray as they have done many. Did I mention guru actually means Jupiter or Moon in Hindi? Ideas of saving the whole world are obsolete. People are at various stages of their own personal growth, thus in the beginning you may have to be a little selfish with your time and attention as you gain new balance. Many are still earthbound, and ideas of even leaving their hometown may seem like too long of a journey. They cannot be forced to grasp concepts of space. This book is written for those who feel their future is in the cosmos, and in fact many things will not make sense if a person is, 99 page, looking to remain on Earth. There is no reason for one to accept the truth of the future if they want to remain on Earth, thus they will believe nothing you tell them. These people are making plans for several years in advance as if they knew of the hour we would release their souls. Many make plans in vain, their highest goals are riddled with limits, and they have forgotten that we are not the body. Reason 82. Many people have confused spirituality with monetary prosperity, in which the two are almost complete opposites. Consumption is the enemy of compassion. If you notice, the main trait we have been given as humans is reason. This keeps us from acting like insects and animals, being at times purely instinctual. When one charges money to give a seeker knowledge, they are in gross error, and the truth will elude them even if it is in plain view. Many will not believe this. Their deeds are written, thus we will declare them back faithfully to them on that day in which it will be too late to balance. That day comes for everyone at some point, it is the only guarantee in this world. We shall put a barrier betwixt them so none may cross. On one side they will see what they forfeited, and on the other they can see what they escaped. Contemplate this in wisdom. Real gurus travel the buddhic and vashanic planes that many already inhabit. They are doing the bidding for the beings who control the regions. They've promised to serve them during their initiations. I'm speaking here of the initiated yogi, guru, lama, etc. As far as the pastors, the Holy Ghost suffices for them, and the witches have their 13 covens. Paranormal feelings and experiences do not denote that you have reached the true path, and one should carefully access all of what is happening in the surroundings when they begin to occur, especially in the future. They will be widespread as many activate. Due to the level of mind control and suppression of thought, many individuals never get the opportunity to truly ponder this stuff, in fear that they may be struck by lightning for offending the gods. Thus they become stuck on the step of what appears to be an enormous religious pyramid fully animated. I've wanted at times to feel the charge of lightning, so I will present the facts and you remain as the judge. 100 page. It becomes obvious that if the gods could do something about this world to make it better, they would have done it a long time ago, before many innocent humans and animals have perished, many of whom are now extinct. I feel I am in the position to make these statements because I have traveled many paths to their completion, somehow escaping the irreversible initiations. As many great men have put it, if you need to be initiated into it, it cannot be wholesome for the people. Was not our first command to give freely of what is the best for us to our neighbor, who are like mothers, fathers, sisters, and brothers to us? So why keep a secret from them? Indeed, these men and women have something that needs to be kept a secret due to its abhorred nature. Reason 83. There is an inclination within us all, no matter how minute, that wishes to be part of something mystical and elite. These leeches of life feed upon that craving that exists within us as a residue of who we really are, except they distort the image to their favor. A midget standing on a giant's shoulder can see much further than the giant. However, if the giant fails to see the midget below him, the midget will be trampled beneath his feet. Joining secret societies always gets one trampled. The moment you relinquish yourself to such a hierarchy, you are admitting you are in a lowly state. This places the strong above the weak, and this is how they operate. Most never obtained what they were looking for, and even forgot what that was. 101 page. Reason 84. Their oath is to keep silent. The ritual keeps the oath in place. As you see above, the pyramid is full of the spiritual leaders, bankers, businessmen, and various others in key places. Joining would place a person on the bottom of the pyramid to be crushed. Their capstone has yet to descend, meaning they are waiting on their god to return to this realm. This will be in 2012, possibly 2010. It is sad that in the end I found most religious dogmas, or should I say Mars dogs, along with their characters to be inexplicably linked to a common cause of keeping us ignorant and under the yoke. At great lengths I wanted to believe the world was perfect because God was perfect and this was the highest form of teaching. Then true knowledge rebutted and said we are the act of creation in which the Creator passes knowledge through. If we can no longer see what is in plain view and use our senses to react against it, if it be judged harmful to innocence, then we have forfeited our gift, which is the right of good choice. The Creator is perfect, however the creation is started from a state where it must learn perfection amongst many other things. Part of the practice is repairing society with the ability that is bestowed upon us. One may write, paint, teach, sculpture, speak, fund, volunteer, and many more things to bring about perfection that will at least reflect on their own personal self, which is the world, but we cannot sit back and do nothing. This is insolence. We have above us now rulers that are killing everything we love with their filth like oil. Has one sat down lately and thought about how many family members and close friends we have lost to this system from all the diameters it takes hold of, such as its medical poisons? They are the real causalities to a silent war that takes place on the battlefield of illusion, where we sometimes forget to look around us to see those that have fallen. It is easy to ignore it as long as it wasn't someone that you may have known, but when it is your uncle that gets called to the meaningless war, your aunt who dies in the Twin Tower ritual, your sister who gets abducted into a cult, your brother who overdoses, or your baby who is born deformed due to the chemicals they gave you as the mother, then you feel like doing something, and it is then you will find you are alone. No longer do we rally together. I saw a woman speak to a stray dog and then look at me and say nothing. 102 page. Reason 85. The silent battle still goes on with oil. The elite have placed war and disease at the forefront while the contamination still continues in the background. The Arabs discovered oil looking for water, how ironic. Before then they considered the desert cursed. After they found the oil, they perceived it as a gift from their god to make them rulers of all lands, especially over their brother Israel. Thus they suffer from mental delusion and greed, prostrating ritualistically at 90 degrees as if we hear them, not knowing the Most High examines the heart and the knowledge of man is foolishness on height. The night was unforgiving since we could not find what the fire did not carry. We lost another to the wolves in the night, a new child. The world was not deserving of her. I am not sure how much longer we can hold on, as the older I must lead, because I have escaped death often and although my limbs have long since given way, but I cannot show it. Hopefully we find others who know this strange land, my pre-Adamic life, lest we perish in it with no story of our existence. A little old lady that did everything the Bible told her to do had an issue with God. Good old Mother Love was praying for the innocent girl next door to be healed, but instead the little girl got sicker and, God forbid, she died. Being a pastor, I was faced with dealing with this situation. Of course, the ones who play the role as spiritual leaders are taught to stay on their toes and have some default answers always ready. If all else fails, a solemn "it is God's will" suffice, but of course you only use that one in emergencies. Creativity is key. Adding more fluff, I came up with "everything is by the will of God and he does what he pleases, which will ultimately work out for the good because everything God does is good." Nice one, eh? Since God does both good and evil as it states in the Bible, what can you really do but just hope they haven't read that one and come back wanting more answers? Most Christians have never read the complete Bible, thus they lack the big picture. When they get into the vicinity of the pastor, it's seldom question time, just time to shake hands and smile. P. Raise the Lord, brother. Why would the Lord need to be raised? Could that be what the final plan is, to raise their Lord? We will see. 103 page. Reason 86. The phoenix is used in the occult symbolism due to a hidden story of all the saviors that have descended to the underworld will rise and return. This is Tammuz, Mithras, Jesus, Quetzalcoatl, Horus, Adonis and others. The American eagle was going to be a phoenix, but this was deemed too obvious since Europe has always used the phoenix as its insignia, and they did not want the settlers to know that the British were silently orchestrating the development of the Americas. A phoenix is also the hidden sign of the Phoenicians, who designed much of our corrupted language. This is where we get the term phonetics. I learned default answers that I picked up along the way from other ministers that were quite sinister. Of course, I had to learn all these things if I intended to be a good pastor and bear fruit. We will skip for now that the Christian God is a male, which is the obvious clue that it isn't the Most High. The ultimate creator being gendered is erroneous, seeing that it would have to be way more than a he or she to create multiple universes, but we will go with it for now, not wanting to begin digging into history his story. So this God did not find it important to save a family from grief and increase an old lady's faith. He would rather not heal the child and leave the old lady hanging on a limb, which made no sense to me. We will examine what happens here more closely as we take this journey together into the doghouse. I would like to state that it is clear that only one of two things are happening. Either the God cannot do it because of lack of power, or it does not want to just wave its hand and remove the problem for some unknown and strange reason called the will. After all, the God described in the Bible has so much power it can just wave its pinky and poof, a better world. The easier route would of course be to heal the child, which would build the old lady's faith even more, thus possibly convincing the parents of the sick child to attend church. But that is often what does not happen, in fact seldom any real miracles anymore, but lots of new cars. Why? My personal favorite was always God gave me a new car. I would think, oh really, did he give you a gas card for that new Hummer too? As you can see, Pastor Bomar just wasn't cut out to carry the cloth after a while, and if I hadn't already made contact with Shekinah and various other unexplained beings, by that point I would have been out the door. Due to the paranormal experiences I had with 104 PAGE, these beings inside the church, I was able to at least come to the conclusion that there was still something alive invisibly orchestrating itself in the church. It wasn't all catharsis as they would like to make you believe, spirits actually made contact. So then I learned a valuable lesson, which is what looks good does not always come from good. First off, because the language is backwards, when you say God you really say dog, don't laugh, this is something very serious. Many people have always been curious as to why God's name backwards spells dog. For a moment while carrying the cross I tried to make sense of it, so I leaned on the notion that the dog was God's opposite because dogs were very bad. This made no sense whatsoever, since many dogs are very kind, and plus there are much more evil things than dogs described in the Bible, like demons or the devil, which would be more like God's opposite. I could only conclude for a while that they all begin with D. Let us just think for a moment, if you were an all-intelligent God and you intended for your name to always mean good, you should probably make it something like Yay, that way no matter if a person pronounced it backwards or forwards they would still get the same thing, right? Surely the creator of multiple universes resplendent and furnished would know this if his lowly creation could figure it out. Not to mention the creator of everything cannot be confined within names, numbers, vibrations, emitted from the human mouth, and if it did it would be much too powerful for us to assimilate and then reproduce. It would be worth it to conclude that the gods, who are separate from the Most High, know exactly what they are doing down to a quantum level. Reason 87. This is the dog star Sirius A, the star of illumination for many secret societies including the Egyptians. They called it Sothis, its symbol is the five-pointed star. There is also Sirius B, called the Pup or esoterically Great Five. This is Anubis. Five was the sacred number of Atlantis. 105 PAGE. As I began to look at a lot of the terminology being used in certain places, it seemed to take me closer to the truth as long as I was willing to take it literally. Our ability to discern what is happening is deteriorating because we think everything is just a coincidence, even though there is no such thing. It is of value to make note of the syncs or deja vus of your life, also dreams. This is how the unseen ones communicate without swooping down on you in full flight, scarring the crap out of you, which would not accomplish the purpose intended. Many ask why the Most High does not just come down here and straighten things out. We say, shall the creation ask the Creator, why did you make me this way? Some even further claim that he did. I will venture out for a quick moment to imagine what the Most High is. This of course is very unwise, since I'm now trying to comprehend such a storehouse of catamount vicence of condescendionic beams, the wise, with five puny senses, and to add insult to injury I have to use English words, but here it goes. Pure unrestricted energy, thus if the Most High arrives anywhere near our galaxy, well, welcome to the next life, because nothing can withstand such force based on common sense, physics, and mathematics. Anything that has come saying it is the Most High is a deceiver, and the truth cannot be found with them, and their works prove it along with their words. Notice that when people pray, as the word indicates, they actually are saying they are becoming the victim and are being hunted. That is after all what prey is, so who is the predator? Could it be a wolf? Where the pastor stands is called a pulpit, but what is being pulled into the pit? They call themselves saints, which is an anagram for Satans. All books of power indicate the Most High is inside of you, so why do so many people when they pray imagine that God lives outside of them, possibly in the sky? This becomes one of many errors we make when we channel our energy to make contact. As it teaches in religions where chakra systems are at least discussed, focusing internally and concentrating on certain energy centers located in your body is one sure way to enlightenment. Once you have accomplished that, you begin to manipulate the energy through your chakras, which are the organs of your soul. Full activation of the chakras will bring an individual to clear unadulterated contact with the Most High. The real miracle is performed by the one who has trained their mind to bring about such phenomena without the assistance of an external being of invisibility causing the phenomena to take place. This does take a certain level of dedication that many have tried to get around. The result of cutting spiritual corners has always been an even greater setback to one's growth. There is no easy way, because it is not hard, it has just been made to seem like it is. Once finally emancipated from being dependent upon the rules and false impedances of natural growth, you will clearly see our purpose here is to become complete. Not fused and packed together with followers who possess nothing of their own creative thoughts and are just reciting like robots what they learned from those before them that were also incorrectly being led about behaving like clones. 106 PAGE. On the flip side, when a person prays, they are in fact relinquishing their power and beginning a process of servant and master. Our planetary ether is saturated with multiple beings on various frequencies above what the untrained eye can see. The ear can detect some of the beings, which will sound like a ringing in the ear. These beings have developed an outer aura encasing their body that makes them invisible, thus they can carry out their work on the material realm without notice. Their voices are whispers that people imagine as their own thoughts unless they are guided. The prayer of the individual, which is often known before the request is even made, is taken into account and a design begins. This is one of the powers of the all-seeing eye. We have way too much evidence linking the Christian faith to Atlantean, Egyptian, and Sumerian rites sometimes being directly plagiarized from the originals. What I am saying in this case is, if a person does their research, which can be done on the internet, and they still do not find the above statement to be true, they could be a victim of mind control, which is okay, we can work through that. Let us remember that the secret to mind control is never letting the person realize they are under its influence. When the ego is created, it will never admit that something like that could happen, it thinks it is too smart. Thus a perpetual system is in place keeping you stagnant, mind control, and the ego eagle. It's time that we realize steel sharpens steel, the only person that can fix you is you. So as the book says, one should make a sober estimate of themselves every day to be sure they are not off the path and have not deluded themselves all puffed up with pride, which comes before destruction. Reason 88. Every part of the physical mind has been mapped. One will have to work with their spiritual mind to avoid delusions. Let us examine why it could be possible that the term God is more of a hidden term which traces to the land of Canaan and many other trails. Throughout our recent history, lots of attention has been put on the land of Canaan. This is the so-called promised land of the Hebrews. Most literature on canon is very non-descriptive as to the people that originally lived there, and this of course is done on purpose. Their religious beliefs, artifacts along with its true name often remain hidden and obscure. After much guidance, pieces began to come together. 107 PAGE. According to the story, when the cursed Cain slew his brother Abel, he was marked with a sign so that all who see Cain would know that he had been marked by God, thus they could not destroy Cain. It should seem odd that although Cain has killed his brother, he is then given a symbol of great protection, just another one of those Bible concoctions where the true story is an esoteric mystery embedded with hidden symbolism, thus taking it literally makes no sense. They do so much of this in the Bible, it's a wonder the book is legible at this point. Generally, the member is trained heavily in blind faith to counteract the feelings which occur when continuously uncovering inconstancies. Enoch, son of Cain, who wrote more literature relating to the fall for a profound reason, noted that this was the double cross. This cross was used in Gnosticism taught in Gnosis, Crete. What is also odd is, according to the Bible, at this point only four people have been created, one of which is dead. So Adam and Eve and Cain are the only people spoke of. Here is the scripture, Genesis chapter 4 16-17, and Jehovah set up a sign for Cain in order that anyone finding him would not strike him. With that, Cain went away from the face of Jehovah and took up residence in Nod, a land of fugitiveness to the east of Eden. Afterward, Cain had intercourse with his wife and she became pregnant and gave birth to Enoch. Then he engaged in building a city and called the city's name by the name of his son Enoch. Once Cain is evicted, it says he left into the land of Nod, the land of fugitiveness, and he knew a wife. This mysterious land of Nod I have traced to the land of Canaan, which became Palestine then Israel. In Palestine they have discovered caves completely excavated by what appears to be a very advanced race for the time that must have been of great stature according to how the caves were laid out. Our biblical story of Abraham also starts off in Ur of Chaldea, and Abraham when leaving Ur enters Canaan where he experiences his first encounters with the God of the Bible. This is also the reason the children of Israel deemed Canaan the land that was promised to them through the covenants made with Abraham by Jehovah that had to be fulfilled. Beside the Bible's report, the record reflects that after the destruction of Atlantis, the few that survived set out on ships. It goes on to say many of them reached land in the area we now know as Canaan. They began rebuilding their empire, warring with the various people currently inhabiting the land. It goes on to report that many sailed further into indigenous territories inhabited by various Indian tribes. Many of these tribes recorded the arrival of the Atlanteans and report that they taught them various sciences, mathematics, and of course a new religion. Being more technologically and spiritually advanced, the natives began to worship them as gods and knew them as feathered serpents because of the religion they taught and the appearance of their deity. Since there has been so much talk of these serpents, we have to at some moment approach the question, are all serpents and reptilians evil? I can only answer this as, are all men evil? What follows, 108 PAGE. Now is perspective, think of this. If you were born a lion, is it natural for you to behave like a sheep? Obviously not, so we all have different characters that at times directly oppose the nature of other species. Just as when ants invade your kitchen because you spilled some sugar, you become their apocalypse when you wipe out hundreds of them with the sweep of a cloth, drowning them as you clean the rag, watching them go down the drain. Many would say this is different, they are not sentient. We would say all things that move are endowed with a divine spark, and if you could split it, it will create an explosion such as you have never seen. This was done so you could marvel at the creation and then reflect back upon the Creator. I tell you the truth, there are high life forms that still call Earth home. They are interwoven in its fabric, and to separate from it would be spiritual death to them. Earth is also our current reference point. If it is removed, it is possible our memories will be disposed of when we reincarnate again. This is of course if we continue to reincarnate after what happens in the future. The best most could hope for is another repeat of life with no memories, in which I'm not really up for. We must admit Earth life is dangerous after a while in our current atmosphere of illusion. It is easy to bring about so many excesses, we not only destroy things around us, but we also bring about the degradation and degeneration of our souls. Experience is not the only thing the soul needs to grow. In fact, experience is a relatively small portion when you consider the soul can eat elements, essence, and gaseous things found in the atmospheres. We must now build a superhighway down the path of truth. Why? During the invasion of the Anu, known also as Anna, life forms from another constellation called Nibiru came to Tiamat Earth to subdue it. Tiamat, known as the Dragon, fought the Anunnaki, who fought back using highly advanced weapons that ultimately split Tiamat. This is the story in the Bible of the dragon fighting the angels. Many of our religions are Anunnaki propaganda. Their main interest was our natural elements, especially the spirit of man and woman termed the gold. Several situations ensued amongst these beings, even a mutiny amongst themselves. These beings are responsible for the Nephilim stories of the Bible. They altered a race of what appeared to be then pure spiritual beings of various types into spirit forms encased in flesh, in which they could slave and master over. There was said to be a few amongst them that did not like the way humans were being abused, and thus they began to teach their favorites the ways of enhancing their bodies by linking them to their spirit to become as powerful as the Anunnaki, if not even more powerful, since we had the spirit element in us given by the Most High. These mysteries of enhancing the body later became known as the wisdom of the serpent. The correct term would be the wisdom of the spirit, who many relate to the serpent because of its spiraling movement and fiery nature. As things began to intensify, word got back to Anu, the leader of the Anunnaki, about the humans and their new abilities. Anu sent Mudjuk in a ship which is Planet X to handle Tiamat, called the Great Serpent, and her offspring, the humans, once and for all. This ship, the size of a planet similar, 109 PAGE, to George Lucas's Death Star, entered orbit around our Sun as the 12th planet in the 10th position from the Sun, hence its name Planet X. This marked the last crossing of Nibiru. Mudjuk used a weapon known in the tablets as a net, called also the Net of Indra. This is some type of atmospheric net that keeps souls trapped on Earth Tiamat, not allowing them to continue their evolution. Mudjuku is Ra, set up the pyramid systems which I explained above as the first matrix. Ra then became ruler of the underworld, which is the place where souls go when they remain trapped in the net but have expired their current physical body, thus they are waiting on a new one. This is reincarnation, a curse. You can clearly see the Egyptian god Anubis serves Anu and is one of them. The Queen of England, who is the ruler of this world, has instilled the worship of Ra, Anubis, and the rest of the Anunnaki pantheism under various Sumerian, Egyptian, and Hebraic guises. This is why religion is now so limited, except for the few who become high initiates. It is them their duty to continue to suppress us. They are doing this at the bidding of their god Anu, who they say is returning with Planet X by 2012. There are many more in high places who also serve Ra, such as the Arabs in Dubai. Reason 89 parliaments are tools for the Anunnaki. They run mystery schools, governments, and practically the entire globe. I have yet to find anyone who opposes this force. They are supremacists, such as the ideas the Talmud discusses about Gentiles, thus if you are not in leagues with them, you are only a resource that can be abused. Christianity was hatched to seem as if it opposed all of this, however it was just another plan to keep humans powerless, thus continuing to stall anyone from activating by denying them information of chakras. We will face the Anunnaki in what will appear to be the first extraterrestrial contact on Earth. Currently it seems Earth will face utter destruction and enslavement by them, however the Most High holds the key element of setting such plans to ruin. You must at least individually entreat the Most High. 110 PAGE. The Anunnaki themselves appear to be originally reptilian, however, they have blended with various life essences and thus their appearances vary. In addition, the Anunnaki themselves seldom interact with humans directly. They use their underlings, who are humans infused with Anunnaki genes, and in that state they are wholly indebted to the Anunnaki and are controlled by them through a mentally collective cellular connection. Other names of the Anunnaki and their offspring are Anakim. This is why Anakin Skywalker is Darth Vader in the Star Wars series. They are the Celtic to all that are Danann sons Dan or the Danu. They are offspring and servants of Sumerian each. Pronounced Elyar. This is why the new name for our planet is ARTH. Three wise men came from the AST, and the major Christian celebration is called Easter. They are the Sumerian EL, Akkadian ILU, Babylonian ELU, and English ELF called by their worshippers the Shining Ones, or is it Sinning Ones? They altered man, a downgrade, calling them Lulu meaning mixed one, and Adepa, model man, who the Hebrews call Adam. According to the Sumerian text, Tiamat's seas were full of souls that could be harvested. This is the hidden meaning behind the Fisher King and Jesus being called the Fisher of Men. When Planet X divided Tiamat into two parts, she released an ocean of souls or cosmic essence into the cosmos. The Greek version of Tiamat was Demeter, which is where we get the term diameter, the cutting or dividing a circle in two, or split. This is how we became separated from our other half. The Egyptian termed these two parts the Ka and the Ba. K-Bar. Reason 90 in Dara is seen in this rare plate carrying the double cross net. In Dara is Canaan plays the role of Ra-Majuk. Their descendants are a different breed created on the eighth day from dust, offspring of the ones who beguiled the pure world. 111 PAGE. What self-aware spiritual entity would agree to a life of slavery? I was enlightened and made aware of what is transpiring, and since my eyes have been open, I would rather die on my feet than live on my knees. The Anunnaki see the earth-bound souls as slaves, criminals, deviants, prisoners of war, detested social and racial groups, non-conformist and undesirables. Hammurabi's code, which later became the Ten Commandments found also in the Egyptian Book of the Dead, became the guidelines issued to this race of souls to give them rules and conformity. Various plans have existed to keep us from reaching our real potential through the art of conviction. Ninhasuk, the Sumerian Hathoresis, was called the Great Cow. Legend says she is the true power behind Each/AR. She was called the Carpenter, the Coppersmith, and the Lady Potter. Later her name was changed to Gabriel, feminine such as Gabriel. Gabriel appeared to the Virgin Mary, alerting her of the birth of the Christ child Jesus. In 600 AD, she visited Muhammad, dictating Quran to him. She is a seraphim, meaning serpent of Raphim or Rephaim, another Nephilim hybrid connection. Gabriel used the caduceus rod to translate the soul of Christ along with the Holy Ghost into the body of Mary. It helps to see this as advanced technology of spirit insemination. Reason 91. The caduceus staff was in fact some type of Anunnaki technology used to transfer spirits into matter and manipulate energy through the tuned vibrations of the carrier. 112 PAGE. Again, the level of mind control brought forth here is profound, since we are taught that we are all children of Abraham and we have all descended from the 12 tribes of Israel. For some this may be true, but let us not forget that Abraham had a father also, and while they were all an heir of the Chaldeans, you had Nubians populating Africa, Asians in the Orient, and various other races that had never heard of Abraham. The Bible speaks of in Genesis a man and woman created on the sixth day in the image of God, and another set created on the eighth day from dust. The difference between these two creations was one had spirit compassion, while the other was very base. This is the main drawback of the genetic manipulation. Many underlings are of the other race of Adams, of whom care more for material prosperity and could care less about a dying world, helping children, etc. Still others are now mixed with both. There is obviously a silent war going on between at least two separate races. Looking deeper into the canine affiliations to clarify, the dog itself is a domesticated wolf, so what we are really dealing with here are wolves, which fits the term, wolves in sheep's clothing. Sheep's clothing is a metaphor for a human body. In canon, which is its roots in the words cane, canine, canine, and others relating to the canine species, there had obviously been some interaction with the wolf later domesticated into the dog. This interaction can be looked at no different than the Chinese and the dragon, in which they claim in their ancient tales were their original descendants. to explain many things that have drawn a blank to most historians, it may be necessary to look further into the true meaning of the animist involvement in various nations. Following the pagan tradition, many would leave their young in the woods around packs of wolves to see if they would take the baby as their own. Of course, this led to hundreds of babies being torn apart by packs of wolves. It is said some were taken into the packs of wolves and the she-wolf would care for them. It is said at times when seeing these youth full grown in the forest, they had inherited all the traits of the wolf, just as the shaman follows certain animals around to gain their traits. This gave birth to the mythology of the werewolf or lycan. Reason 92. Romulus, where Rome gets its name from, killed his brother Remus. They both were suckled by a she-wolf who found them abandoned in the wild. 113 PAGE. The scriptures say the Nephilim that roamed the earth during the time humans were created sinned against woman and then began to sin against the beasts. What I have more than enough evidence to prove is that statement meant some type of insemination between animal and demigod that brought forth what we would now call mythological creatures. In the old days they became revered, feared and worshipped. It can be proven that many of these beings make up the tales of ancient mythology when centaurs, cyclops, Cthulhu, and various other part man part god part animal creatures were roaming about. This was known as the abomination. In addition, it states in the ancient text that when these creatures died they had souls, thus they did not perish but roamed upon the face of the earth, and man called them evil spirits and they could be evoked. This is the accounts that can be found in the books of Enoch, the first man to write about the God of the Bible and what was taking place during those times. Interesting enough, his books did not make it into publication and remained in the esoteric circles for hundreds of years. The list of the names of the fallen angels located in the books of Enoch were very important to the elite for evocation. Reason 93. Some of the offspring of the Nephilim that were reptilian and amphibian hybrids lived much longer and became kings. This is how the bloodlines began. The intermingling with woman continued in order to spawn successors. Since the ruling powers have clearly sprang forth from ancient Egypt, a little Egypt 101 wouldn't hurt. The Great Pyramids point to the Sirius star system, more commonly called the Dog Star in Canis Major. On January 1, Sirius reaches the meridian point at exactly midnight. This is, of course, the beginning of the Gregorian year. In Egypt, this was the most important star. It is not only the brightest star in the sky, it can also be seen from anywhere in the world, which many stars cannot. 114 PAGE. The Egyptians called this star the goddess SOPD, pictured riding side saddle on a large dog and at SDEG time as an actor dog. She's known as the wife of Osiris W. Azario. She was also known under as Walhi Northeast Huon. And this same star is Sothis and Sophis W as ND, which is where the Greek got the TE Sophia from their channel of EKS Ermeyer illumination. S Sophia was the exact equivalent of the Holy Geo Ghost and Shekinah W, which is the power E Jesu used to be Arus ring about miracles Alu with TH Wood and SM on his staff passed from Aro and the Ak on. Actual Egyptian text as Sis Sothis is noted give birth to the Morning Star then the MS Ing Owing Nas. Morning station is Jesus of Aref Nazar Areth. As a TH bust of Isis says, Iasis Iha brought forth the Seiamavat Sun Sun. Reason 94. T Pyramid of Egypt to the Potasaru and also A the Ids Trtalasamenti the Underwar ERLD. Once on again C Sirius is indicated by TH 5 pointed star. This would may all those using the 5 HDS and EPO pointed stars are evoking energy fro Sirius WNG on which spells the under S reward in TH afterlife. The Heatlanchans bu the Egi Puil Tipshan Pyramus Tempan Po Mids MPLES Autals to the deities O he worshipped in Atlantis. Atla Antis means as door of Atlan Shteran. CTNG was to ink the it is a fact that pantheism can be confusing at times which it w created t do and c Egyptians had o 3000 gods and g over g goddesses th was lot of confess here ts in all the time and each with iped. the a advent of so many po enter in Egypt the local god of the Ejo opal nged's Egyptians were always pyreact up by wish surrounding tier ribs who admired Egypt's success accrediting it to their patron go and thus becoming sngr and s devo worship up ppers. There is a constant seesawy back and forth betreeing nd between Osiri Horus, Isis, and Ra is. Con nside how many servants are in th world v his versus mas the god abounder the huas, ds and humans are left p powerless are made to serve. The serpent dynasties never stop ruling t and oes t but they simply branched y out and coming setting up hierarch led g chis and pyramid systems of con nt rul everywhere they seek a duopal. Med roam about the air land seeking who they could devo leaving rsubd the po by war. They roam a tra of blood from the delta to the Americas alde, 115 page. Reason 95 The various demigods of Egypt were of the lineage of ancient Atlantis. Other deities such as the African bees became part of the pantheism due to the power accredited to him by worshippers in Africa. Egypt absorbed all the powerful deities throughout the land and thus the people were wholly dependent upon serving and caring for the gods who often manifested as the royal families. Generally they were trained in techniques of mental power, then given a rod to intensify those powers. To the people they had the power of gods. Everything that is living first examines what it was before, so it knows what to become next and this can be seen even with microscopic life forms. This means that if they tell us lies about what happened in the history of this world, as a race we face not only heavy mental alteration but also, 116 page, possible extinction. We are not continuing on our true cycle as I explained above about descending. Real Zodiac does give a pretty accurate layout of your character but we have the ability to change our ways permanently thus altering our DNA, this is the marvel of the human race. Considering how long this charade of playing God has been going on, this may be the first time at least in this segment that such knowledge of the inner workings of our society has been placed in our hands. Not to mention this is probably the first time a mass of people are at a comprehension level to at least grasp what is happening. In the history of man the masses have been powerless with little intellect. The human mind which I mentioned before is more like a wheel turning. When we get set into habits it creates a groove in the brain. Deeper grooves are habits that have been practiced for longer periods. This is where terms like stuck in a cycle, or getting into the groove of things come from since a cycle can also be looked at as a wheel. It has been also observed that it takes 22 days to make or break a habit, good or bad, which is the effect of allowing the grooves to flatten back out. So the human mind becomes a record with grooves playing oftentimes the same vibrational song every day. The first thing you realize during astral travel is that you are not the body, you are more like the alien on the movie Men in Black that is very small but powerful sitting in the operations seat of a giant body, something like an organic Montauk chair. The other thing you will notice when you look down upon your body is that obviously your memory and senses are not contained in your body because you are still using them. This is one secret of obtaining higher character, even if you have not astral traveled before, knowing that you are not the body releases you from the many expectancies of normal life and gives you another framework, the soul, to build upon. When you have dreams if you notice the sheer detail that is involved in the environment you realize that we are a lot more than they are letting on about. We are capable of doing amazing things. There is even a part in our mouth that makes three different types of saliva for different situations. It becomes obvious that we are not in accord with the standard parts we have been fashioned with bells and whistles that we have not even explored. This knowledge of enhancing the body has been held selfishly by the elite alchemist but now we are hacking Orpheus and in a moment he will tell us everything. Most are completely unconscious of who they were in former lives. Sometimes we catch glimpses of it in dreams, often smells and sounds remind us of something that we remember but cannot wholly identify. The sacred order of the Marys in fact had unlocked the secret of certain essential oils that had the ability to regress anyone smelling them into memories of their past. The loss of collective life memory has everything to do with how strong your spirit is when it departs from this world. We are living in a time where if you look deep enough you can find most of this information. This is all we need and possibly all we will get. I see it as useless to keep coming into lives in which we have no full knowledge of our previous experiences. The best advice I can give the reader is to begin to work on growing your spirit, which we will talk about as we go along. 117 page. Symbols. The elite communicate in symbols and designs which are far more powerful than words. These markings are embedded in our consciousness and serve as triggers for various emotions and concepts. I will take this time to tell you that you should not become a warrior when you begin to discover what is going on and anger or vengeance moves you to combat it directly. You should always keep your weapons in your mind and not in your hand. Warrior also means a person who worries warrior so much once they figure out how much strength and cunning the other side possesses that they actually send energy to the negative forces when they become overwhelmed and behave foolishly. Remember, what we face as a society is something that we all must confront at some point. One person cannot fix this world on their own, but each person can do their part in getting out information of the truth. This way those who are still confused can make up their mind as to which side truly resonates with them so they can go about it fully and not half-heartedly. The whole construct of this book is not to down any religion, race or belief system. It should be seen as a detailed observation and not a judgment. In the book of Revelations it says, "How I wish you were hot or cold, but you are lukewarm and I shall vomit you out of my mouth." This means that individuals should not straddle the fence. Whatever they are going to be, they should get on with it. This whole activity of truth seeking does wonders for our complete growth, so it should be looked at as such. Everything that you have experienced will all come to your aid one way or another when you have purpose. Let everything you do have purpose. With this information, you now have a chance at saving yourself and others. The last thing you want to do is become so scared you no longer want to know anymore. In the unknown you can be found, because you have not yet discovered your true self, obviously, because you are not even flying or at least floating yet. I give this pointer very sternly. Fear is indeed the mind controller. You are stopped at times from learning anything more because of the internal feeling of death and the lies about what really happens after death. Many people hold on to their religious preferences because they feel it will save them in the end, even though they break most of the rules of the religion. It would suffice to know that when you die you go to the place corresponding to your mentality or frequency, hence the term judgment or a judging of the mental. Society has been trained to love lure and ceremony, thus the preacher with a fiery sermon gets more attention than the sometimes boring metaphysic who is explaining how the body can really work the miracle they are so busy ranting about to make it seem like such a big deal. Individuals will begin to need their powers in order to survive. That is the pressure placed upon us in the end of this segment: evolve or face extinction. Once the mental portal is reopened and the person becomes open-minded again, most of the instructions, activations, and experiences will happen during sleep. If you, 118 page, were completely transported from this world never to return, it would take place in your sleep. It is unclear what happens to your body here. Some say it continues as if it's you and behaves just like you through residual memories, action and reaction. People never know you are really gone. In Egypt, where much of this is amplified, we find the cult of Isis. Many believe with the masculinity of the pharaohs the women played only roles as normal queens called by them, Fats. In all actuality the Egyptian empire functioned as a trinity and the female part of the trinity became absorbed under Isis. To maintain it as a trinity, all the other gods and goddesses were summed up under the main Enid. Clearly Osiris, Horus and Isis make up the Egyptian trinity. Sin, Shamash, and Ishtar make up the Babylonian. Isis represented Ninhursag, Ninela, Inanna, Ishtar, Mat, Mer, Mary, Mut, Nephthys, Hathor, Nut, Diana, Astaroth, Astarte, Aphrodite, Athena, Tuat, Bast, Usertesen, Ida, Mylitta, Baalath, Anahita, Ashur, Azith, Kodesh, Sophia, Sothis, Sode, Shekinah, Magdalena, Europa, Ganymede and many others. This became possible because it was the so-called goddess female energy that equated to the enlightened portion of spiritual training, so when an initiate came in contact with the actual spirit of the religion, it often personified itself in one of these goddesses who all remained under the same umbrella. This is why even to this day Isis under many forms is worshipped heavily. Our Statue of Liberty is a rendition of Isis. Her main sign is dollar, which is the word ISIS compressed into one symbol. Some of the countries of their origin are Assyrian Ishtar, Phoenician Ashtoreth Astarte, Syrian Atargatist Erkito, Babylonian Belit Mylitra, Arabian Ilit Alilut. Again, their home is the asteroid Venus, Sirius, and the Pleiades. Their species seems to be completely foreign, hiding under the guise of illuminating warrior goddesses. In the ancient text it says a fragment landed in the river Euphrates shaped like an egg. Somehow those who interacted with this egg became infused and infected with its essence. Those infected became the first communicators of the knowledge and message these beings brought to Earth. These are also the beings movies like The Bee and The Knowing are describing. They have an agenda to take over the world completely, and they have major assistance from just about every main religious and social group. This is due in part to the powerful role they play in religion. The natural instinct for man to gravitate toward a mother goddess figure comes from the separation of our other half. The want to interact with this magical feminine being is played on and exploited by these imposters, some of whom are responsible for the initial split, or Maya as it is more properly called. In addition, for the woman, since the goddess is androgynous, he gives her the son of the sun. She begins to see this as her husband, protector, and father figure. Most women are deprived of one or the other, if not both, in today's common society. There is obviously not just one faction doing all this. You would have to think, man and woman are a very advanced species, it would take a collaborative effort to keep them in the darkness of what the true reality is. 119 PAGE. Reason 96. There was a saying, the devil has many names. I first found that to be untrue when learning who Satan was, especially since Satan and Lucifer are actually two different beings. When considering ISIS, however, it all makes sense. This is how the reoccurring savior theme exists, and the key component is always the mother with immaculate conception. Immaculate conception is really the deity having some type of intercourse with the woman, producing an offspring. This offspring then attempts to become ruler of the world in his father, the king's, steed. Many of the hyperdimensional beings want the title Lord of the Earth, so they never cease these divine conception stories. This happens now through the royal families, such as Prince William becoming the next king. Their family history, however, is riddled with the involvement of various forces. They are carrying the bloodline, so they most certainly are not completely human. I do believe we have something in our constitution about that. What a joke. We as human beings are utterly ruled over in this dimension, our needs are extremely meager compared to what we are originally entitled to, and yet those needs are seldom fulfilled. These forces also extend into the dream world and the afterlife, so there is no rest for the weary. Until they are confronted, they are consistently hatching plans to make an individual believe none of this is going on, somewhat of a strange zombie phase. I will tell you now, you can live every day in such a high state of energy, and these beings are jealous, they cannot do the same, they are forbidden from it. It has gone, 120 PAGE. Asleep and them never to awaken again because of their corruption. All the blending, enhancements, and greed for power has made them numb, they don't even feel alive, they are the undead. This state I speak of that you can return to is not just the feeling of everything going well, but the feeling of having the perfect companion. Something so gratifying that everything external does not take an inkling of attention from it, as if it does not exist. You become wholly endowed with it, spiraling together, forming endless states of ecstasy. Their most powerful weapons are their religions. This gives the power to them directly from our own souls. It is time they are removed. I'm not sure if this will take place in large numbers, however, I am sure that it does not matter, it is what you do individually that counts. There is a lesser light which emanates from below that spawns countless distorted images, Soon they will be placed in shoal in which we fixed a door for entrance and none for exit, then the world will see freedom, if you but knew. Many looking now will say he is joking, but we do not jest. Now unveiling the goddess will take place as Madame Blavatsky claimed to do when she wrote her book Isis Unveiled. She of course was in no position to do such a thing being fully initiated herself and remember their oath is to keep silent. However, they are allowed to push propaganda and disinformation. Once again the goddess as we know it was a play on words. There is actually a symbolic story being told about Adam and Eve in the garden with the serpent. It is known that this story should not be taken literally but has a much deeper meaning. It started with this uneasy feeling that there was something that was a big secret about the word women. You find omen in the remaining part of the name meaning a deep hidden meaning. Eve is the root to the word evening. The Hebrew version is even weirder since the name used for Eve in Hebrew, Hiva, actually means serpent. According to the original Zohar, a major root of the creation story, it makes it clear that the serpent in the garden was a female serpent not a male like it is commonly believed. Pre-Adamites or before Adam were masculine spirit beings called sons of the sun who took physical form and mated with these women. These female serpents known as the race of Nemaya and Lilith, caused chief angels like Azza and Azrael to fall from their post and mix with them. The Zohar continues to blame Amalek as the wicked seraphim while Metatron is called literally the good serpent. This is incredible, it admits Metatron is actually a serpent and goes on to admit that Enoch became Metatron once he was translated to heaven, thus Enoch was also a serpent. Several times the tribe of Shem makes it clear to indicate they are inbred with serpents. This makes it concrete that the Enochians are linked to the serpents. It says the priest came forth from the dead Sephanim who died in labor. The baby was born with the sign of the priesthood which was a lustrous scaly hide. The baby had just been brought forth but sat upright immediately and showed the sign of the priesthood and they were struck with terror. In the many Hebrew texts where it says, 121 page, he created man. To them he is the feminine attribute. The tetragrammaton is yod he vau he. The yod yah is the masculine fire entering the feminine he birthing the child vau vi, and the world will return to he, so they believe. Cohen, Hebrew for priest is an anagram for Enoch. Reason 97,000 of children every year are indoctrinated into animist religions depriving them of their true potential. One of the most widespread religions in the world, Judaism, still keeps Moses' depiction with horns on his head. The Kabbalistic tree of life is the same tree from the garden the serpent offered the so-called fruit from. This fruit was signified as an apple which is a pentagram in its center when cut in half. As said earlier that pentagram is the symbol of Isis Sirius Sothis and her consorts, also her opposite, when inverted and they are together not separate which we will address when it's proper. Someone once said that if you ask a person for an explanation and it becomes very confusing it means they do not know themselves or they are hiding the truth. When asking someone in India teaching through Hinduism or someone in Judaism teaching Kabbalah how to increase union with the Most High you are buried in thousand-page Gitas with confusing Sanskrit words or mile-long scrolls of rabbis with nothing better to do than take one passage from the Talmud and make a thousand-page explanation. Truly do you believe it is that hard to enhance the spirit? Of course not, these people are placed in the way to make the journey lengthy and hard. As I said above many have not obtained what they originally sought, which was freedom. Now they are enslaved by the religion and their subconscious wishes to have company in their misery. 122 page. Reason 98 The five-pointed star is not the symbol of the perfect man it is the star of contact for Sirius and all the various beings that make up the pentagram including the inverted. These featherweights think the Most High has left this world never to return, and they are having a free-for-all. They know not we even watch the all-seeing eye. Looking through ancient times the moon was actually not feminine but masculine. The moon went by the name Sinandar. In so many ways the god Es shows that it is actually an androgynous serpent. Many women become moon goddesses to link with more women that are about healing and tapping into the feminine power which of course is wonderful, However, I have seen the start and finish of many of these groups and it almost always leads to initiations, and then if you reach the height of these organizations like those in Mount S. Asta or S. Edona, just like ancient Esakara, they go into deeper forms of yoga like Katha Hatha. Giving the neophyte strange names with false meanings to chant while opening chakras. Doing things such as imagining thousands of Buddhas filling their soul. Then they tell you that it's really all Hinduism and the power of Samahdhi and learning to wield Shakti, the serpent energy comes into play heavy with Shiva. The person is subtly lulled to sleep while the flute plays with the lies that the serpent just means complete wisdom. Yes, the serpent has a lot of wisdom and it has been fooling man and woman with it with the helps of hybrids and traitors. Of course, many men joined the cult of the goddess imagining that it was a haven for beautiful forest queens who, when approaching or should I say flowing towards you, bathed you in swells of spring marigolds as rabbits and deer bound behind them joyously laughing and singing in delicate waves of solfeggio. The serpents could of course create that illusion long enough for the person to be lulled into the trap. They eventually become so laden with negative spirits they are deluded and confused. The Masons, Rosicrucian, and Ishmaelite assassins are a primary example of organizations that have tricked the spiritual arm of men with this type of nonsense. The most they could produce was a debased bacchanalia. I encourage women to keep yourselves on guard. Just to show you how much the serpent is suggesting that it made things, look at these words of power. 123 page. Spiral. When you go out to the ocean and look at the shells, you will see the spiral force. When you watch waves of energy, you will see the spiral force. When you look at your fingerprint, you will see the spiral force. All the way to the S-whirl in your head, you will see a spiral force. It's safe to say our creator uses a spiral force when making things, no straight lines. Spirit, the ethereal being of consciousness. Sphere, our cellular level exists entirely of spheres. Spin, another word to describe the spiraling motion. S all, the life force of heat, warmth, and vitality. As discussed before, the S is the primary symbol of the serpent in the English alphabet. All of these forces, like the sun, soul, and spiral, had other names that did not begin with S. It was simply motion. However, when the 70 languages were introduced across the world, they all received this indoctrination of SS vibration and thus a false relation to the serpent that has permeated the subconscious mind. This mind control technique makes it easier for us to go with the story that is being told more and more, which is the serpents are our creators. A serpent has no voice box and can only whisper, thus everything they say sounds like SSSSSSS. They are sometimes called the whispering ones. A famous prayer in Islam says, Allah protect me from the whispers of Shaitan. 124 page. Reason 99. Adonari is androgynous and keeps a serpent around the neck as most all Hindu figures. Hermes, the thrice-born who is Thoth, was also androgynous. The joining of the masculine and feminine were taken to these vulgar literal levels as another deterrent from true spiritual unity. In Hindu teachings, one is taught to work from the root chakra up, thus much of their teachings are based on tantrics and the manipulation of sexual energy. Many are now saying the proper ancient teaching was from the crown chakra down, thus the person escapes the traps of getting stuck in an animalistic carnal phases which often happen when lower chakras are turned on before the higher ones. This is also why many New Age leaders such as Rael are heavily into sexual expression rather than mental and spiritual enlightenment. Their doctrines are based on sexual freedom, which feels good but does not feed the original desire of enhancement. To understand these entities is to realize that the world is a lot more diverse than they are revealing to you, and we are not the only intelligent life form here by far. Here is a big example. When the United States went to the moon, which happened although not when they filmed it, the speech that was written for Neil Armstrong read thus, "One small step for man, one giant leap for mankind." What is this difference between man and mankind that they must be separated? Could they be possibly alluding to something here about another race like we pointed out in Genesis? Furthermore, what kind of man leaps? Of course I know the answer, but I'll leave you to do the brain work. If you can't figure it out, read on and it will come to you. In legend, Isis is always with Anubis, a dog-faced god sent to be her protector. Nephthys's sister is said to be a female dog also. What is also interesting about this tale were their strange relations with one another. It is said that Osiris mated with Nephthys by accident, birthing Anubis. Nephthys was Isis's sister, thus connecting Isis to also being part dog, part serpent. The child between Osiris and Isis became Horus Horse Mane / Isis did not suckle the child but instead allowed the child to suckle from Anubis the dog. Isis relocated to Byblos and wept that she could not bring Osiris back to life after he was cut into 14 pieces by his brother Set, until a certain time, since the 14 pieces signified the 14 phases of strength of the moon. The story continues, it was during one of these crying sessions that a woman named Astarte appeared to her from the court of the goddess. Astarte is where we get the word star from. The arrangements made between these beings have always been kept a secret until now, not to mention this whole story is completely allegorical. On the Masonic tracing board at the top of the middle pillar sits a seven-pointed star known as the Star of the Pleiades, also called the Seven Sisters or Seven Hathors. It becomes evident that there is actually a group of female spirits, who are immortal, that are enlisted by the goddess, who have been attempting to steer the destiny of the human race. These women are better known as the Fates. These Fates are the key women who mated with the Nephilim and produced the offspring of heroes and villains with various forms and powers. Originally the cult itself was under Apis the Bull, 125 PAGE. Thus many of these women were depicted as cow goddesses. Later that morphed into something entirely different, including them now being looked at as some space-faring group of illuminating goddesses rather than a cult that would sacrifice a bull while the Vestal Virgins bathed in the blood. How soon they try to make us forget as old forms attempt to take on new ones, but we have the records as the agents of the Most High will always dictate faithfully. Reason 100. The inside story is the initiates were betrayed by the goddess who sold them out to the serpent. As you can see by the Masonic tracing board, this stems all the way back to Mars. There is no telling the extent of what is really going on and what kind of trouble the elite have gotten us all into. Even worse, their code of silence keeps their lips sealed. 126 PAGE. Let us keep in mind, men cannot bring forth child whether immaculate or through inseminations, thus the creatures that are part humanoid resulted from the union of woman and various beings. It is no doubt this was sometimes done by force. Alchemy was the title given to the art of blending elements. These elements were not always base chemicals, many were organic. The blending of plants and animals to see the results was something of a religious science in Atlantis. This is why many of the creatures have aquatic appendages. Reason 101. This may all seem a little weird now because this part of our past has been placed in the dark for obvious reasons, however these beings deified, meaning they are worshipped and are still alive today. Many creatures were part amphibian, part beast with incredible spans of life and spiritual energy. The ocean is vast unexplored territory. One could not amass the resources to attempt to find their kingdoms, and even if they did, they would never return. At the current level of human intelligence, there really is no reason for other life forms to take interest in such an uneducated, limited species we have been turned into. The real mystery of Atlantis is the island was submersible, it never sank, they rule from below. Undersea, Davy Jones's locker, David and Owens. Before we get back to serious business, I will say that the human has extreme potential. I will show you how it is clear that the knowledge of who we are is being hidden. Even while writing this, I can feel the doubt of the people that will read, but it will lessen as the realization sets in. This is also what symbols do on a very deep level. I have purposely embedded this novel with certain symbols that will allow you to remember who you are. Be sure to think of my definition of remembering, which is 127 PAGE. Reconnecting your various scattered members as if you were also cut into 14 pieces and had to find all of them to become whole again. Smaller in number we are, but great in mind. Reason 102. From what I have studied thus far, it is highly possible for a company like Sony to make a game that would activate and balance your entire chakra system all while you were trying to break your previous high score. It's that easy. The body has a system of various energy wheels. When they begin to oscillate, it is unexplainable the things that you can do. Laying crystals on chakra centers and going to sleep is another way to get chakras at least cleared. There is a big difference between cleared and activated chakras. When one chakra opens, even if it is the root chakra, it will be accompanied with a paranormal ability. The system can be powered up through breathing techniques such as whole body breathing. The chakras are the jewels encrusted inside our bodies. Once they began to shine again, the true splendor of the diamond body will be seen. There are certain abilities that come by default when the body is fully activated. They are make oneself small in an instant, become infinitely large at will, defy gravity with a levitation field, touch any object at any distance, dive through solid ground like water, total control over all the elements, create and destroy matter, instant materialization of thought. It is also clear why such abilities may 128 page need correct training and also correct judgment on timing of when to bestow such gifts on a person. If this was the norm in society, we would be an entirely different race. Giving a person these abilities with the mentality they have now developed due to our world status quo would be a problem. So this makes something of a catch-22. This is why one has to work on separating themselves from the normal mold of thought. Something is always watching and always guiding. The moment the student is ready, the master will appear. A few important facts about the binary star Sirius. Sirius is a white sun many times bigger than our own sun. One looking at the size of Earth compared to many of the other planets may be left with a dismal effect. Reason 103. Be sure to keep in mind Venus is an asteroid almost the size of Earth. Mars was 3 times larger than the Earth, and now this is all that remains. Amazingly, each human corresponds to some quasar or star. 129 page. 130 page. In Roman times, Sirius was known as the Red Star, and they sacrificed red dogs to the star. Sirius B contains the entire mass of our Sun in a globe only 4 times bigger than the Earth. Sirius B's surface is 300 times harder than a diamond, while the core is 3,000 times harder than a diamond. This planet makes 23 rotations on its axis per minute, thus generating a huge magnetic force. Every 50 years Sirius A and B come so close together they begin to spiral around each other at enormous rates. Once huge tidal forces are generated by these two stars, they eventually flip-flop positions. This energy is eventually released to flow on magnetic lines to the Sun, which transmits it like a lens to all the planets. Sirius B is the far more massive out of the two. In Harry Potter, the evil character Sirius Black or Sirius B is introduced. Despite that Sirius plays the bad guy, one should not believe Harry and the rest of the witches and warlocks are good. This is a game the elite love to play. They make two sides that I like to call bad and worst, then they make people choose either way they win, like Democrat and Republican. Earth cycles have been full of various creatures of a different variety, as you have already seen. Some have died out and only their spirit remains. Some have been hunted and killed for various reasons, and still others remain underground. The floods did from time to time wipe out many land mammals. However, aquatic beings such as amphibians always survive, thus the oldest kingdoms remain under the ocean. The primary oceanic race to come forth was Atlantis. Their species include that of Ones, known as the fish god. Ones was father of Poseidon and Dagon. Many say he had 12,131 page sons. These amphibians had at times war with the reptilians, and that's why through history it appears the serpents are actually fighting each other. True, the serpents do at times quarrel amongst themselves with the survival of the fittest dominancy embedded in their cultures, however, they heavily quarrel with the amphibians, which all look the same to the commoner. 132 page. Reason 104. Onus, god of the sea who connects with all aquatic creatures, dolphins, whales, octopus, etc. Dagon, the son of Onus, is pictured here also, the fish being the reason why the Pope wears a fish hat. They worship Dagon and various others. Remember, pantheism is the belief and worship of more than one god. A hidden mystery is in the holy sea. They are referring to the sea in which Onis rose from. In addition, Caesar means sea, key snakes are. The mother of King Dagobert was said to be rapt by Dagon while taking a swim in the sea. His name means priest king of the house of fish. This was the beginning of the Merovingian bloodlines. The mare is the root of words such as mermaid. Mare means a special knight. They are called Merops, who also connect with Mount Meru. This is how they control you in the Matrix, by elusive consent which cannot be reversed unless you are aware of it. This is the doctrine of the Holy Sea. The soul is seen as a fish ishim out of water when it enters into Earth, the material square. The instant the mother's water breaks, her cargo descends the birth canal. There is a doc on hand to take the delivery. Once born, the baby is under Earth jurisdiction of maritime law as opposed to natural law. These are the laws of the Matrix one must abide by. A certificate of birth or manifest is written itemizing the condition and specifics of the cargo. The baby or vessel is given an SS number, then granted privilege to go ashore. If it gets in trouble, the accused self finds itself in court, once again standing on the docket. The soul is considered dead while sailing in the earthy container. It is a ship in the bottle seeking the dock that will allow it to unload its cargo, the human biological transformational apparatus, and re-enter the cosmic ocean. If all this doesn't seem fishy to you, keep reading. 133 page. To perceive in all this that one human has value without personally doing spiritual work is a drastic mistake in proportion to size. The current theme is that we are all connected, and the human is very valuable to the future of the universe because of that connection. It would be better to perceive it this way: we are all connected to something. How that something affects the complete system is what's of value, meaning are we just one screw in the device, or are we the generator? Surely we can lose screws and replace them easily, but the generator is another matter. What part we play will be determined by whether we educate ourselves to the highest potential possible to reach our full magnitude, to gain the choice that exists beyond the influence of such large celestial bodies in space and the diabolical fiends of Earth. This is called the Great Reward. The fleur-de-lis, which is one of the most popular symbols of today, has many meanings, as you can see above. Even Dagon has it on his crown. First, it symbolizes the three pieces of holy wood of the cross. This is the deepest meaning. Apparently, this tree of life was actually a real tree, and pieces of it were taken about through history by important personages until finally they crucified Jesus on it. The tree had more meaning than Jesus in the Gnostic sects, as Jesus' twin sister Magdalena would carry the bloodline and birth the future Antichrist. This lineage has birthed a succession of Antichrist and Christ personages through history. To have an Antichrist, you must first have a Christ, so they created both. Symbolically, the tree is also the three, which is the Trinity, the triangle, or the top of the pyramid. The cornerstone the builders rejected, which is Masonic jargon. Reason 105. On the left, Jesus is seen using the holy wood to heal. On the right, Thoth is building energy with the rods and transferring that energy through the Ankh. 134 page. Below you will find a story that barely survives written, or should I say it carved, in 1483 before the King James Bible was written in 1611. This reveals the true origin of the Christ and the cross, lest they continue to lie and deny it altogether and have us all confused in the lake of fire with them groping about wishing a drop of water would be given to cool a tongue. The latest ploy is Jesus had a cousin named Jesus also, who was from Gamala, and he was the imposter, not the real Jesus. They will continue to create more and more explanations until every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess Jesus as Lord. There is no way a story can survive for thousands of years with the exact description of what occurred. It is a fact that the story of the Savior created through Immaculate Conception, along with special healing powers, who dies and is resurrected, is shared by Krishna, Hindu Sakya, Thammuz, Hesus, Adonis, Alcestos, Artes, Crite, Iao, Indra, Aeschylus, Bali, Mithra, Xalcote, Quirinius, Thulis, and Witoba. Do not be unwise and believe all these figures were attempting to imitate Christ. Christ was attempting to imitate them. Reason 106. The letter that looks like an F with no cross is an S, so this reads Seth buries Adam and puts three seeds of the tree of life under his tongue. 135 page. 136 page. 137 page. 138 page. 139 page. 140 page. Reason I only took the time to place these woodcuts here because they are on the verge of being lost. The originals remains in the British Museum. This story concludes with a piece of the wood being taken to Rome and used for magical purposes. All those in possession of the wood became world rulers. The last Tsar of Russia had a piece of the wood in his ring. This is Aaron's staff that budded, and the staff that turned into a snake and swallowed that of the Egyptians. Symbolically, this story is all about the tree of life, which made men magicians and gave them supreme dominance, connecting their lineage back to Set, I mean Seth. As you can also see, the four beasts around Christ on the cross in the final cut. INRI, IGEN NATURA RENOVATURA INTEGRA. Reason 107. As you can see by these three artifacts predating the arrival of Jesus, the story of the crucified divine Savior on a cross is nothing new. Even the picture on the right, which seems like an exact depiction of Jesus on the cross, is actually Osiris conscribed way before the story of Jesus on the cross. Every era has been accompanied by a crucified Savior story. There is no use in reinventing the wheel. It always serves to disarm the people, making them believers of something that is coming to save them and wash all their sins away. Your sins and wrongdoings are your own past. Get over them and balance them out in the present by your deeds. Nothing or no one can do this for you. Adults are behaving as children with such naive beliefs. People will soon see where all this leads and who these men really are. 141 page. The fleur-de-lis was also the symbol of the exotic blue lily. This was a flower that grew out of the marshes of the Nile. The Kemet Egyptians were masters of chemistry and alchemy. This was the core religion of the priest. Chem is where these words derive from. In fact, the Egyptians had extensive knowledge about minerals, plants, and animals. This is the meaning of each side of the triangle. A little digging uncovered that during the initiation rites, the Kemites would procure concentrated doses of the blue lily and administer it to the initiates. They would then place the vibration rod, more commonly called an ankh, against the back of the initiate's neck to transfer vibration. After this, the initiate would be led through the inner chambers of the Great Pyramid. Each room carried a particular frequency that would prepare the body to go into an astral death state. Finally, they would be placed in the sarcophagus, and depending on the initiation, his or her soul would descend to the underworld, Mars, or Sirius, due to the zero-point field of the Great Pyramid lined up on the Van Halen belt on six major ley lines. In that moment, they would meet the Lord Dog of the underworld, Anubis, Baal, and others, all surrounded by the hounds of hell and many other goons like Ra, hanging out in the netherworld of Dan, which is where we get the word dark. The fleur-de-lis is also the symbol of the jester's hat, or simply the trickster or magician who concocts magic and illusions. Just as you see the three wise men come from the east, also known as the Magi, you will begin to see that although it is profusely banned in the Bible for all others, oftentimes people who are in the grace of God are affiliated and acclimated with magic. It goes further to admit that Moses himself was schooled in all the wisdom of the Egyptians. Even in Egyptian legend, there are stories of other men parting large bodies of water just to find jewels that had been accidentally dropped in the sea by the women who were rowing the boats. Janus and Jambres had no problem duplicating Moses' magic. When it came to turning the staff into a serpent, his magic seemed to be a little more powerful. These acts are also symbolic but are mistakenly taken literal. It also mentions Dathan, a well-known name in adept circles connected also to the Nephilim. In the Bible it says it was Dathan who caused the Hebrews to make the calf again. 'Tis true, the Nephilim have enticed man to do foolish things like worshipping a calf. Of course, this also has far-reaching issues that affect the spirit, but let us just consider what this does on a basic level. How much time will one waste and how dense will it eventually make them if they consider their ultimate god, a calf? Then they turn around and eat it. The true meaning of the word magi is lost at times in the modern pronunciation. It was originally pronounced magus, like maggot, the larvae of a fly. A magus, also known as a mage, magi, or magician, gave themselves this name because they worshipped Beelzebub, the lord of the flies, better known as Baal and Baal. Many names like Baal, Jehovah, and Moses are titles and not actually names of individuals. They form collective energy. Those who followed a certain god would change their personal name, thus joining themselves to the god. Ezekiel and Daniel were both servants of El, while Isaiah and Nehemiah, for example, were servants of I, called also Jah. Many of these names connected to the same godhead. 142 PAGE. Reason 108. The mage and jester played an important part in the king's retinue, as it was their responsibility to keep the king entertained and informed of things of the spirit nature. Eventually the king would be hypnotized by the magician, thus the magician was really the king. In this picture you see the magician standing behind the king and the jester at his side. 143 PAGE. The beings of the underworld are the overseers of the Illuminate, and they give all the orders as part of the unseen hand. It was understood that a person would never disavow because these beings were capable of hyperdimensional travel, shape-shifting, etc. Once the predestined time elapsed, the initiate was resuscitated by the Keemtown adepts, and that was the beginning of the induction into higher degrees. Reason 109. The pyramids are constructed to produce a zero-point field. What you see above ground is duplicated below ground, giving the whole structure the shape of a diamond or platyhedron. The lowest point of the pyramid is known as a menti, or the underworld. These pyramids also link up to the plateau on Mars, creating gates for hyperdimensional travel through a series of wormholes. If you came to these areas in the old days and asked for Moses, they would laugh at you because of how many were initiated into the art of being a Moses, like Thutmose III. The same thing is true with the title Jesus, which was an entire Egyptian mystery school in conjunction with the Nazarites. Looking for Jesus in those times would turn up various characters with magical powers. Even in the Bible, Jesus himself runs across another man named Bar Jesus the magician. Even Jesus warns that when he leaves, another will come with the same name as him, saying he is him, but do not go and see him. Jesus alternates as this rouge character that doesn't even want to get crucified, as seen in the Garden of Gethsemane. There was no limit to the pretenders of the old days attempting to create new. 144 PAGE. Religions to find worshippers and servants for their gods. Some were far more convincing than others. Many of these schools connected under solar and lunar brotherhoods, sharing common gods, goals, and ghouls. Others were in direct opposition, wanting to create their own religion to harvest members, at least for monetary purposes. Many times spreading of the new religion came down to the purse, or money issues, which it took more members to increase. The scripture says the serpent took a third of the host from heaven and they fell to the earth. If you see how numerous the stars are, which all correspond to living entities, you began to realize how many of them are here, and they never tire in fooling man and women into worshipping them. The story of the serpent even survives within the stars, as a star chart will reveal Alpha Draconis, one female dragon wrapped around one third of the stars, including our pole star Polaris. It is said this begins the importance of the number 33, or a third. Old tales from England concluded that you had to defeat the dragon if you wanted to exit this universe, because it guarded the pole star, which corresponds to the exit and entrance points of our immediate solar system. Later it was found out by Western thinkers through Hitler's paranormal division and Madame Blavatsky's meetings with the dark Tibetans that the stars also corresponded to actual places on Earth. The pole star was thus in Antarctica. An opening was found there that led to a jump gate with various uses, especially instantaneous travel throughout the planet through wormholes. 145 PAGE. Reason 110. The pole star has been mapped since ancient times. The Earth contains various entrances to the center of the Earth. In other places, natural wormholes have been located that have served as portals or gates entering and exiting Earth. The 33rd parallel, located 33 longitude on the planet Earth, has been the main spot of esoteric activity. The Roswell crash that began the alien phenomena was mapped on the 33rd parallel. Nazareth, the birthplace of Jesus, is on the 33rd parallel, Nagasaki is on the 33rd parallel, Babylon in modern-day Iraq is on the 33rd parallel, the Mother Lodge of American Freemasonry lies on the 33rd parallel, Bill Clinton was born in Hope, a town on the 33rd parallel, U.S. Highway 666 is on the 33rd parallel, the no-fly zone for Baghdad was on the 33rd parallel, Sidon, the seat of time on Earth, and the temples of Baalbek are located on the 33rd parallel. The White House is on the 33rd parallel. The Twin Towers fell exactly 33 years after their groundbreaking ceremony in 1966. Samson and Jesus both died at age 33. The number 3 was sacred to the Egyptians, and in the code it is also another form of an S3 plus 3 equals 6 S6, which is also the letter G. Notice the similarity in black letter Lucinda and Algerian G, G, 6. This is of course another hidden meaning to the G in masonry beyond geometry and generation. Much of this will make a lot more sense, if it already doesn't, when you get further along. You will begin to see the matrix fall everywhere right in front of your face. 146 PAGE. Reason 111. The use of sacred geometry has profound effects when it comes to binding and controlling regions. There is a perfect relation in color, shape, sound, and number. If we were taught only these things and not the garbage of the curriculum, we would all be extremely intelligent and gifted in a high degree. The elite have taken this knowledge and used it against us. Unless we begin to have a firm grasp on how all this works at some point in the near future, the positive will eventually have to face, or risk being wiped out, by the negative. In true reason, one does not assume good will always triumph. They morph into the role of good and ensure they have put in motion some type of true energy to bring that idea about. We should always ask ourselves, did we do our best? The answer to that should be based on a point in life when you really know you had done your best. That's called a point of reference. It is of great value, especially in meditations. A hierarchy system exists amongst these beings, just like the one set up in our military, except much more animated. Demigods like Beelzebub, Baphomet, and Quetzalcoatl have their own, 147 PAGE. Follow Oas Altho, they all answer to something even low than THUKLLGERHAM. The J is to get job there, the P up anyway they can, and the Divi play Y aiding of POW goes on in the DAO where NRKNESS where you can see. As re not they often tell why this O is more of an illus why you old Eason until you wake you to what's really going on. You upping man of these beanie beings are responsible for creating this SOCAR RENG old illusion or Maya slash slash Maya. The play on word here is ODS obvious, for example. Ill Illuminati, I illusion, ill, illegal, pill and kill, in time I W show LL will you how they all relate and who is the cult behind such illiterate treachery. It would suffice to Aredo Pritate RY. D say N that it is very ill, as you can see by the words it has to expray itself. TH World's L now N's is S he largest pharmaceutical company is Lily Illy. L. Reason 112 the Illumirianity is actually an Italian word o the organization founded by Marchesa N. Isisabella Aldo Obrandini P. Palavicino. There is Stetil TH Ordinati, Intrepidi, Amaristi, the Academiae, Mise of Esquilina, Infecundi, Faculty, DFI, Debili, Immobili, Ririchlia, Lilinxes, Arca Adia, and Liturgica to only name a few. Some of TW. These group ES make the LUM Humanati LU like the YOC YMCA. Las ST Tim Wiche I make the H the San of Mem had and ES Mbears. The TH underwo has REM world mained Chloe ached, and M many TH things UW never see and never know, will ERE specially if why didn't NU enhance you spiritual RL position. WH these geohen roops eliminate the NNHANCE themselves with the strong of arch TH and just consu as barfuch homit temmo feb moa womit. Some will ask, why all TH to take TH soul, IWSHA does not begin with checkmate, it is a me has the will sthte, proc sedger, con nside or this every pawn has the opportunity, no matter how slim it may be, to make it to o the o other side o the board where it see become any piece I wants. All around you are pawn who have d can e at all you wns don't know the are pawn thus they make ill moves imagining they are knt hansy equal g knights or f even k-eens. Your c current war is run a 64 bit hy old is hypercube d designed by hybrid queen hydra that is rested in hyper ida borea. Thy is the ma his atrix. And why say you can handle the truth? You e? The Wamaya actor D to Oli mean to divide or split in T first, TH occurs I modern meaning NT to hen it's of illusion heek happens after the foe CH orma takes place. In T ancient books it's STS the tates the division was at us side included U right bra Roth soul call the bar, Arain, her led abba cutting you off from our other S which I and our contact with the other world where our closest pass CTOD Aralal also K known as Udop Helgaranga or Dao exists. T world that I speak of is actua the word that prek ble this TK LIRLD seeds this O in time because one time does not EE exist there. Many Piat believed T Reptilia and Nunak upgraded us, in all a plethian key D actuality it was a Darwin grad D activida. Ating our P pineal gland and genet D tickly in sera ting and activating a reptilian, 148 page portion in our brains there's attached to ceremony. There has been a large amount of research on the reptilian portion of the brain. It makes us only think of survival, food, clothes, shelter and basic instinct. It begins to deactivate the much more creative human portion of the brain that conceives beyond daily life into art, feeling, creativity, and expression. When you can operate in both worlds you can move things around because time does not exist in the other world like it does here. When you come back into this world things manifest immediately which is called keeping a foot in both worlds and was shown being done in Egyptian art. This world could be naturally reached through the dream state if there weren't so many nets and webs that one's astral body gets entangled in when they go to sleep thus keeping them from traveling beyond the immediate globe of influence. This is why the Maya depicted 2012 as being the end of the illusion because all this would be found out. The gig is up. Reason 113 The Maya, more correctly known as Maya which is one of the seven stars in the Pleiades did much of the ley line work for the serpents. Other tribes like the Aztecs, Yucatan, Toltec, Incas, Texoans, Peruvians and Araucanians all built pyramids or other structures on the ley lines and began human and child sacrifice by instruction of their perceived masters. 149 page. People tend to forget that the Maya also predicted their own destruction 500 years before it happened. This occurred because they were taught to believe in destiny so much they could not avoid it. The sheer fact that destiny has tiny at the end of it turns me off. This world is too small for me to dissect. Our future should never be associated as such, it's despicable this kind of degrading. Their extensive knowledge of time was given to them by the serpent. This is mainly evident because it wasn't even a time chart for Earth's processions but Sirius. They are often seen in sculptures and pictures bowing down to these serpents who gave them this faulty system of time. Let us think clearly, the one who gave us time was the culprit known as the Watcher or Watch just like a timepiece this is another name for the Nephilim. We find lots of hope also in the indigenous tribes many of whom had unlocked the ability to disappear totally from a reality in a blink of an eye which can be done when groups of people get together and pull all of their energy in collectively, thus creating a gate to other worlds formed within the collective mind of the group. Reason 114 The Maya long count calendar functioned as a clock of the universal time of Earth's evolutionary development based on the energies of Sirius Sothis. As you can see on the right this watchmaker obviously is in the know. I will take this moment to elaborate on the damage of the split mind. First with the mind split there will always be some type of internal duality within the individual, a constant pulling from one side to the other depending upon what time of the season it is. This duality was remarked by the ancients as the two horses pulling your chariot as can be seen on the number 7 tarot card. unless you could get them to run together, they will go in separate directions, eventually ripping you in two. This other side has a lot to do with being complete in our thinking. It is given the term masculine or feminine depending on your sex. There is no space in this book to elaborate on what is masculine and what is, 150 page. Feminine because of the complexity of the individual creation, but there are a couple things that can be of value to consider. Reason 115. The chariot is the body comprising two different sides that are the energy plus slash just like a battery. When the sides are balanced, progress is made. When one side is unbalanced, there will be no movement, as one side will always pull or drain the other. As far as the first card, all the symbolism is indoctrination. The eight-pointed star of Alub, the Sphinx, the square, the Egyptian solar disk, crescent moons, etc. Feminine energy is intuitive, while masculine energy is analytical power of reason and strength. Women say men need to be more sensitive to their surroundings in order to get in tune, which is true. There is seldom any response by men on what women get to do. This is what I've learned: if we sense all the time without analyzing, we will just go with the flow of life. That current flow of life in our present world condition is actually going in the opposite direction of progress. It is headed towards decay as anything material will, it just is, and this is something that has happened before. It is also true, when we become too analytical, all we have is mountains of data that are not attached to feeling, thus higher senses cannot be activated, so there can be no power to do anything about your findings. Especially when it comes to divining the real truth, or the root of what is going on in your individual life, so it can be adjusted properly so you can have a stable foundation. For males, it is of value to know that females make at least 50% more paranormal contact than males. One main reason these beings can communicate with women better than men is because they possess a womb. This is known as a soul matrix. The fluid is highly magnetic, and as any yogi can tell you, there is actually brain tissue around the stomach region. In short, the stomach area is the keeper of chi force power. This is where it is harnessed and stored. Women have a high generative cycle of this magnetic fluid in their menstrual blood or plasma, which is also a high energy substance. This was known by the Knights Templar as Sangreal, which they would drink in their rituals of the Holy Blood, the Holy Grail slash Magdalena. Unfortunately, this also results in more women being used to harness the 151 page. Dark powers, without questioning whether or not it's correct, they just go with the flow. As the New Age woman develops more analysis, she will again deal a heavy blow to the Wicked One, who is no match for the fury of woman but is ever seeking to use her prowess. Reason 116. This type of propaganda is being directed at the young women so they can imagine witchcraft is a coven of women sticking together. In all actuality, it is to place one under the service and spells of the horny gods. This reflects in how women's bodies are desecrated and disrespected by these cults. These are also called corn gods, which is a term coined in Egypt, where their entire economy depended on corn at times. As you watch the horn continue, it is obviously wicked, like we talked about with the, or you have words like torn, pawn, mourn, worn, etc. All implicating the culprit once more. Men are no better. Without the feminine side, they personally need to see the physical result of their spiritual practice, if it be any, in order to believe. Due to many practicing for personal gain, they only engage in the arts that produce fast and vivid results. This form of magic is the most dangerous, as it is not a graceful energy but a magic based on receiving, not giving. Thus various pacts are formed by men with lesser spirits whose presence can be felt easier because they are dense, slow-moving vibrations, chaos magic. This is called the gambling of the soul, which is why gambling is forbidden by wise men. Even the numbers on the roulette table added up equal 666. What gambling does is it allows the person to jump to a higher phase in this material world without proper preparation. If a person has many bad habits and they happen to strike it rich, the latter condition is far worse than the former. They now have money to feed their every corrupt desire. 152 page. Reason 117. This is Baphomet, the horned god of Mendes. When inverting the pentagram, this being and legions of others are evoked. As you see with the propaganda above, witches and warlocks use both sides of the pentagram, and both sides bring about various energies we will call negative feminine and negative masculine. These are extremely unbalanced, distorted energies. The flute in the hand of Sothis is the same flute Pan, another horn goat god, is often seen with. The balance comes in play when you are open to the emotional, sensual side of the world, thus giving you extra perception, while your analytical mind is able to place it in its proper category due to previous experience and research. These two become the perfect self-sustained match, being capable of handling energies the proper way, expelling darkness and elaborating on the true light. It is also of value to realize that to become a teacher you will need both of these in order to deal with the two states of mind if you expect to mend them. I will also remark that masculine and feminine, 153 page, personalities are not limited to any particular sex. You will find many individuals with a mix and match of these traits, and it will be your task, if you choose it, to replace what is missing like a surgeon. With that being said, do make a mental note that SIR, which is a title given to a member of the High Court, and SOR normally used as the root of words like surgeon, along with SIR as in serpent, SAR as in sargon, and SOR as in sorcerer, all are head serpent terms, meaning that this is the common acronym they refer to themselves by on this dimension. Also keep in mind, most surgeons have no idea of the root of the word, nor do they care. The caduceus is the only hint at times they get that the whole medical institution is none other than a lab belonging to the hybrid serpent set up for the various manipulations of the human body, such as vaccines. This also gives us a better resolve about choosing the proper companion. There is seldom a bigger hindrance when you are on the first levels of the path than the insignificant other. Many times two people have paired up for a prolonged period and are now only together because of the amount of time they have been with each other. I overheard a person once say, "Well, we have been together for 6 years and I owe it to try and make it work." When leaving this earth there will be just you, unless your mate is on the same frequency. Of course, in this life we desire to find compatible partners, however, if we are personally just beginning to learn the truth of things, how can we expect our old selves to have chose anything good and balanced for us? I was able to sum the whole relationship paradigm with this mode of thought. If he or she is concerned about their soul and its growth, then there is a chance the relationship will work. If they are not concerned, then the other conscious party will most assuredly be dragged down. This will come about oftentimes not in the intent of the idle individual, but rather the things they engage in. For example, if you are cleansing your mind and body seeking more clarity and a mate comes home after being in a bar for hours, they are actually carrying a great deal of negative energy. When you share a bed with them, you are even more vulnerable than they are, since there is a vessel no longer matter to the spirits, it is your fresh energy the spirits want, they already have the other individual. Even deeper than this, as long as you are yoked to them, you are not only carrying them, but also the load that each of you acquire through life along with yourself. So in short, if a person does not care about their soul, which is of the highest value, how can they care about you? Although there may appear to be something there, it is not complete, thus it will falter at a certain point, most assured when you need it most. The weak link on a chain only breaks when extreme pressure is applied. This is the danger of the illusion, many people are pretending, and this makes them very unstable in certain key areas. One of the main tactics of the deceiver is to match you, the seeker, with an unbalanced mate that may only have an exterior show of compatibility. This is why lustful pictures, flirtatious men and women, risque scenes, and various types of propaganda all are put in place to distract the seeker and convince them to first try to find eternal happiness outside of themselves, which is not possible. Of course, you attract what you are, so if you are incomplete, but 154 page. Zarching, you attract another incomplete person that is all searching, and thus the blind foe on so allow the blind until they both fall into a pit. Why I this magician or magi who I see the whiz m call zards who w worship lizards collaborated a guy man inst on go ng individual favoritism. Th pact simp reads that in six lives he plies and woman a low time agon exchange for and they will reign over ma and woman will make up the group w called th elite. Thy and man ll we he hoes who are see closer to the top of the pyramid ge generally are of the pure bloodline that have remained the same reen as ed since the first anean term England this is cng called holy blood or h grail. They main why holy ntain a constant link with the collect hive me h tivind. Those further down the pyramid and dwn degrees after initiation sometimes ns really the whore eyes rival truth which is the not only have to do these date bidding in this life but they wiyo ties g also belong to t them in the lower dimension, a maddening reality that consumes from with gts in. Many m say they would nev make sue in agree may why veruch emant, however, they j have ne been just ever presented with such a deal. They will be asham at what the result may be. Imald med t imagine how many of w toda youth w do anything just to become a star in whole eyes will oliewood. It is of value t understood that the to an e elite do not need a person to join the team that have a w e ed n air I waiting list.